Week number 8 takes us indeed to Barberton as the Magics play host to the Tigers from Massillon, Washington High School. I'm Dave DeNatale here in the press box here at Rudy Sharkey Stadium. It's going to be a lot of fun tonight. The undefeated Massillon Tigers checking in 7-0. And on a mission here in 2019 after being runners-up last year, taking on the 5-2 Barberton Magics. We'll talk to you more about the matchup right after we have the national anthem. Alma mater here before we get the anthem, so let you enjoy the band here as we get ready to go. Barberton and Massillon, our WKYC.com game of the week here in just a few moments. All right, our national anthem played there by the Barberton High School Marching Band as we welcome you back inside Rudy Sharkey Stadium here in Barberton. There we go. Flying solo tonight, Dave DeNatale with you as the 5-2 Magic's going to take on the 7-0 Tigers. And it's been a lot of excitement about this game throughout the region over the last couple of days here because this is the first time these two really traditional high school football powers in Northeast Ohio. It's the first time they've met in a game since 1995. And that was a game that was played at the old Akron Rubber Bowl. This is the first time that Massillon has been here for a game against Barberton since 1957. And, oh, by the way, the Tigers, as they do, they won that game 30-0. But this is exciting, and a lot of people in Barberton have been looking forward to this. And you know, anytime you get Massillon, it's just that there's a mystique that comes with this program and the name and the orange and the black. And you know, I'm just looking over at the visiting section, and you may have seen it as the band was playing there during the anthem. It's full. I mean, they traveled well. It's not a very far drive. It's up Route 21, about 25 minutes or so to get here from Massillon. So it's a relatively easy trek, and this is a lot of excitement. Now, the excitement for this game for Barberton tempered a little bit because the Magics are coming off of a loss here at home to Aurora last Friday, 31-7. That shocked a lot of people. Not that Aurora won. I mean, Bob Mihalik's team is playing very well this year. They're undefeated, 7-0 heading into tonight. But the fact that the Greenmen came in here and really put a whooping on the Magics at home like that surprised a lot of people. So how does Barberton react to that this week? How do they, you know, put the emotions in the right frame of mind and get ready to play against a Massillon team that isn't just 7-0. They are dominating everybody they play. They're averaging 50 points per game offensively. They're only giving up about 11 points a game on the defensive side. Their closest win this year was a 42-21 game against a squad from Pennsylvania. I mean, that's everybody else, they've pummeled. In-state, out-of-state, doesn't matter. And this is a team that had made it to the state championship game last year in Division II and played Hoban about as well as anybody this side of St. Ignatius has played Hoban, but lost. And that's now been the focus for the senior class especially and for head coach Nate Moore, who's in his fifth year with the Tigers. Get back to the state championship game and this time get it done. Massillon, with all their mystique and all the great tradition since the dawn of the playoff era, Massillon's not won a state championship. The last one was in 1970, but since they do the state playoffs and the champion gets decided kind of on the field more so than, you know, in polls and rankings, the Tigers haven't won a state championship, and they feel like, hey, this is their time. Now, the Magic's on the flip side. They come in with that 5-2 record. They find themselves now outside looking in if the playoffs would start today. They are ninth in Division II, Region 6. So they are desperate for a victory. If they don't win tonight, it's not the end of the world because some of the teams in and around them have their own difficult matchups. So a loss tonight doesn't necessarily knock Barberton out of the playoffs, but a victory would mean a huge, huge boost for this program. And as you can hear in front of us, I mean, I'm looking down here, the Barberton crowd, getting there. Not quite 100% full, but getting there. And the Massillon crowd, the visiting stands, completely filled. No surprise. Tiger Nation travels well. Barberton won the toss. They have elected to receive. They want the football first. Keep the ball away from Massillon. Magnus Haynes will kick it off for the Tigers. It's angled to the right. It is caught by Caleb Vega at the 6. He'll go along the left sideline and taken down at the 19-yard line. And as Vega goes down, flag goes down, and then a second flag goes down. And you probably will have some form of a late hit or unsportsmanlike conduct as one of the flags. I'm not sure about the other one. Officials having a powwow here, so we'll see where the Magics will start the football. When they do start, Chase Haywood operates it for the offense for Barberton. Still waiting, and we have holding on the Magics. That's flag one, and unsportsmanlike conduct, Tigers. And so, let's see, do we just... Where are we going to start the football here? Officials are marching back the holding and now moving ahead on the unsportsmanlike. And they have decided that we will start with the Magics having the ball at their own 27. Chase Haywood, the quarterback, he has thrown 14 touchdowns this year, 1,200 yards passing. He's completed 65% of his passes coming into tonight. Cameron Macon and Markham McKinney, a pair of sophomores, will carry the load for Barberton as running backs. Ryan Watkins, Caleb Vega, who we just mentioned a few minutes ago, Tim Starcher and Joe Johnstone are the wide receivers. Kyle Hutchinson at left tackle, Jacob Saylor, the left guard, Connor Angeloff at center, Logan Kasek at right guard, and Tyler Eberhardt is the right tackle. Out of the pistol, 1st and 10 Magics. Haywood turns, gives it to McKinney. He had a hold to the 30-yard line, then it closed quickly as Noah Richards, one of the linebackers for the Tigers, stepped in to make the stop. It's a 3-yard gain, 2nd down and 7. Massillon operates from a 3-4 defense. Ethan Tobin, Emmanuel McElroy, and Corey Campbell up front. Calden Williard, who's a good one. Ben Krishbaum, Noah Richards, and Preston Hodges are the linebackers. Anthony Pedro and Isaiah Roberson are the corners. Luke Murphy, Robbie Page are the safeties. 15 on the play clock here, and now the Magics are just getting out of the huddle. 2nd down and 7 at their own 30-yard line. Haywood will again go to McKinney, and this time the hole closes, but he bounces off the would-be tackler, gets the 1st down of the 40 to the 45, and pushed out of bounds right at midfield. Tough, determined running by Markham McKinney, and it's a 1st down for Barberton. They'll spot the football at the Massillon 49. It's exactly why Barberton wanted to get the football first, that when they won the toss, get that offensive momentum going. Now, wait a minute here. Do we have a flag? We do. I didn't see. They dropped the flag over here on the near side. It's a holding against Barberton. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. We'll move it back to the 35-yard line. So, wipe out what would have been a 16-yard run by McKinney. That was a fine piece of running in the open field when that hole had closed quickly. Instead, it's a second down and 2. So, technically, give McKinney 5 after all that's done. On second and 2, back on the ground to McKinney, and this time he won't be able to bounce it outside. He is brought down by Ben Krishbaum behind the line of scrimmage at the 32-yard line. So that's a loss of about 2, and it'll bring up a 3rd down and 4. 10:52 to go here in this opening quarter. Barberton, Massillon. Week 8, WKYC.com High School Football Game of the Week. Thank you for your votes, and thanks for joining us tonight. There's a delay here. Something was wrong with the play clock. It stopped, and now it's running again. And it's at 5-4-3-2. Barberton's going to burn a timeout, I assume. Yes. Okay. So the Magics will talk about it here. Head coach Tony Gatto in his 6th year here at Barberton. 45 wins, 16 losses since he came aboard. Barberton, actually, the last 2 regular seasons went 10-0, ran the table. They were 12-1 in 2017 and ran smack dab into Archbishop Hoban on their way to one of their 4 consecutive state championships. But then last year, again, Barberton 10-0, but they were upset in the first round here by Tri-Valley. That one really took a lot of people by surprise. And so, as we said, if the Magics are going to get into the postseason, and it's certainly still possible, but they're going to have to do it from being outside of the top 8 here in week number 8. So out of the timeout, Barberton back on the field for a 3rd and 4 at their own 33 as the ball's on the left hash. McKinney stands to the right of quarterback Chase Haywood. Receiver in motion, that's Charles Hornacek going over to the wing on the right side. Now 4 wide receivers, 3rd and 4. Here comes a jet sweep to the 35, 36-yard line. But Tim Starcher is going to be about a half yard shy of a first down. Although as I say that, the near side official looks like he wanted to put it at the 37. That's going to be awfully close. Closer than I thought on the initial glance. The Magic's all huddling around the football saying first down, but I think the officials want to measure. Tim Starcher has been an effective receiver for Barberton this year. 10 catches for 160 yards. That's his 10th rush of the season. And he looks like, from where they have the chains, I believe he's a little bit short. And do my eyes deceive me? Officials are really looking. Yeah, short. Not by much. Not by much, but just short. And I would imagine the Magics are going to go for this. I mean, this is one of those where, you know, if you're Chase Haywood, just go under your center. Or I would actually go under right guard Logan Case, who's 290 pounds. Because if you go under center, you've got Emmanuel McElroy there. McElroy is 330 pounds at nose tackle, although he's not in there on this particular play, but he's a load. But, you know, Tobin is 230 pounds. C.J. Harris, who's on that D-line right now, is 245. 4th and inches. The Magics will go, for the moment, out of the pistol. Now they'll go under center. Let's see if Haywood will just keep it. Trying to draw them off sides, and one of the members of the Magic just had a false start on that left tackle. Now, both sides are pointing at each other, but I think this is going to be a false start, and it is. So instead of 4th and inches, it's 4th and 5, and Barberton is going to punt the football away. So the holding penalty that wiped out the McKinney run and the false start that took them out of a 4th and inches really come back to haunt the Magics. And let's see. know if that's Ballard back deep to receive this punt. I don't think it is. Yes. Easton Brown will kick it away. Single safety at the 32. Well, I tell you, Massillon almost went off sides. Got to be careful. High snap. And Brown will pull it down. A little line drive kick. It'll bounce inside the 30 and roll to a stop at the Massillon 24-yard line. As that time it was Eric Thurman was back deep to receive. But normally we've seen, when we watch Massillon, Jaden Ballard does that a lot. He actually has a touchdown as a kick returner and a punt returner. Speaking of Mr. Ballard, he and the high-powered Tiger offense on the field for the first time tonight. Aiden Longwell, who has thrown 16 touchdowns to just one interception. He is the all-time leader for Massillon in touchdown passes. Passed Justin Zwick earlier this year for the school record. Longwell's the quarterback. Terrence Keyes stands behind him in the pistol at running back. Three wide receivers, first and 10 Tigers at their own 24 with 9:02 to go in the first quarter. No score. And it'll be a give to Keyes. Running left side. He gets to the 30. Out to the 35 and dives forward for a first down as he'll take it to the 36-yard line. And Barberton saying Keyes, when he went down, he fumbled the football. But I think the official saying the ground caused that. So it'll be a first down pickup for Terrence Keyes. Jaden Ballard, Andrew Wilson, Lamp, Jerron Hodges are the wide receivers. Zion Pfeiffer will get a lot of time at running back tonight as well. First and 10, Tigers. Gain of 12, and Keyes will get it again, and this time gets submarined by nose tackle John Jackson for Barberton and put down for no gain. Barberton will operate out of the 3-4. Kenyandra Turner and Tommy Brunty are the defensive ends. John Jackson, who made that tackle there, is the nose tackle. Caleb Vega, Ryan Watkins, Sonny Fox, and Nick Blasinski are the linebackers. Second, they gave Keyes a one-yard gain there, so it's second and 9. 8:17 to go, first quarter. No score here in Barberton. Out of the pistol, Longwell will look to throw. Has some time, pops it over the middle, it's incomplete. Looking for Andrew Wilson-Lamp at the 41-yard line. And Malik Spragling was over there, covered him pretty well, and will set up a third down. Threw that in traffic there. Joe Johnstone and Spragling are the corners. Charles Hornacek and also Tim Starcher are the safeties. Anthony Pedro will check in as one of the receivers. As he will go out with Hodges and Ballard. All will go wide right. One receiver left. That's Wilson Lamp. Third and 9. Back to throw Longwell. Has time. Now he's flushed. In trouble. Throws over the middle. It is incomplete. Was looking for Ballard, but good coverage downfield by Barberton's defense and a Massillon 3-and-out. To start the football game with 8 minutes to go in the first quarter, and we'll see Magnus Haynes in the punt. Now, Haynes, as you can imagine, hasn't had to punt the football very much this year with this offense of the Tigers, but when he does, he's very effective. Watched him in warmups. He averages 40 yards a kick, his long this year, 52. Ryan Watkins in single safety at his own 20-yard line for Barberton. No score here in Barberton. Low snap. Picked up by Haynes, gets the kick away, a high boomer. Watkins will let it go, and it bounces out of bounds near the 35-yard line of Barberton. That's exactly where they're going to spot it, first and 10 at that particular point. So pretty good job there by Barberton's defense to force that 3-and-out. Now their offense will come back on the field. Did not see them throw, I don't think, on that opening drive. That's the combination of runs, but the problem for Barberton on that first drive, penalties. Holding penalty nullified what would have been a 16-yard run by McKinney. And then you had the false start penalty on the fourth and inches. So break the huddle. Shotgun here. As McKinney stands to the left of Haywood from the 35. And it'll fake to McKinney. And rolling left is Haywood. He's going to tuck. He's going to run at the 35 and dives forward near the 38-yard line. Robbie Page, the free safety, came up to make the tackle. But they'll give Haywood about 3 yards on that scramble. It'll be second down and 7. Haywood doesn't necessarily want to be a running quarterback. He's run the ball 44 times this year for 55 yards. That tells you that he's had some sacks. And I think last week he had negative 31 yards rushing. That tells me Aurora really got in there early and often on him. But I mean, Haywood is a good athlete. He can certainly run if he has to. Second and seven. As McKinney moves to Haywood's right, and the shotgun trips to the right, and they'll fake to Haywood, and it's Haywood running it, and he'll go to the right side near first down as he crosses the 40, takes it out to the 44-yard line. I think it was Darian Williams who made the tackle over on the far side. It was, and again, they're going to mark it just shy of a first down. It'll be third and inches. But a well-conceived play that time is they faked to McKinney, had everybody fooled, including me, and a pretty good run there, and I think they're going to measure this to be sure, and for Tony Gatto to see how long they're going to need this here to get a first down. 6:44 to go, first quarter, no score. First visit since we started the WKYC.com Game of the Week to Rudy Sharkey Stadium here in Barberton. It is a beautiful, top-notch facility. I got to tell you, there's a TV, there are at least two, if not three, radio stations here tonight, in addition to, obviously, we're here, and there is ample space for all of us. I mean, this is really a terrific facility. Beautiful field turf, and it's a great atmosphere, and of course, the weather, the other thing tonight is the weather is really cooperating. Temperatures, we started tonight right around 50 degrees. They did go ahead and say Haywood got the first down on that pickup. So first and 10, Barberton at their own 45. Here's Haywood, and he'll give to McKinney. A little stutter step action. He's brought down back at the 44 for a one-yard loss. Ethan Tobin will get that TFL, 5.5 TFLs for Tobin now after that one, in addition to three sacks. Tobin's a 6'1", 230-pound safety. Massillon has, by our count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 young men who are Division I college football recruits. Terrence Keyes, Aiden Longwell, Luke Murphy, Jaden Ballard, Andrew Wilson Lamp, and Terrence Rankle. Not bad. And there will be more. The aforementioned Colin Woolyard, I think, will be a Division I recruit before all said and done. He's only a junior. And we got a movement along the lines as Barberton prepared to snap. It looked like they were setting up for a jet sweep, and somebody backpedaled a little too soon. And that's another penalty here for the Magics in the early going. False start, will be back to the 39-yard line. So Barberton moving in reverse here. And now it's a second down and 16. Now, the good thing here, though, for the Magics, the quarter is going by quickly. They want to tighten and condense this game as much as they can, and they're doing a good job of that. 5:15 to go, first quarter, no score. Magics now with a second and 16 at their own 39. As in motion goes Tim Starcher. Haywood return, give McKinney, bouncing left side, gets to the 41 and then ripped down there by Luke Murphy. Murphy is a good one. He just this week committed to play college football at Kent State University. Golden Flash is doing a good job in local recruiting, by my dad, which has one Tyler Carey back at our three new studios smiling. Two-yard pickup there for McKinney, so it'll be a third down and 14. But that's a key, for especially Kent State, Akron, Youngstown State. Recruit well locally. Keep these Summit County, Stark County kids in the backyard. Third and long. Here's Haywood rolling right. Has time. Stops. Now he's in trouble. Hit as he throws. Looks deep right side. Pass caught. First down at the 28-yard line of the Tigers as Tim Starcher, the 5'9", 160-pounder, went high to make that catch. And a great job by Chase Haywood, who saw the pressure coming and delivered a strike knowing he was going to get hit. And put a beautiful pass down for Tim Starcher. First down Magics at the Massillon 28. That was on a third down and about 12. Give Barberton's offensive line a lot of credit there. And I know Massillon might not have necessarily been in a pass rush mode, but they gave Haywood time there. Back on the ground. Here comes McKinney. Runs left side. Keeps his footing and takes it down to the 25 for a gain of 3. I got to tell you, Markham McKinney, every time he's like one, there's a late flag down there. And I'm wondering if It's almost similar to the holding they called earlier. I'm wondering if we're going to have another holding here against the Magics. I don't know. This time I think they're pointing towards Massillon here. Yeah, this is going to be against the Tigers. Let's get the call here. Dead ball, personal foul against Massillon. That will move the football inside the Tiger 13-yard line. Automatic first down. So at some point after McKinney was brought down, there was some form of a late hit there. 3:42 to go, first quarter. Barberton in the red zone, trying to strike first against the heavily favored Massillon Tigers. Ball at the left hash. As Haywood moves everybody around, Charles Hornacek goes tight to the right. McKinney stands next to Haywood. First and 10. And the give is to McKinney. Bounces left. Cuts it back inside at the 10. Got tripped up as he took it down to about the 7. One of these runs, Markham McKinney is going to bust out of that first tackle and score a touchdown. And I think that might have been Woolyard who prevented the touchdown by just getting a shoelace there of Markham McKinney. 6 yards on the gain, 2nd and 4. As we go now under 3 minutes to play in this first quarter. So Barberton can get a first down without getting a touchdown. The run out of the pistol. McKinney stands behind Haywood and fumbles the snap. Ball loose on the turf. It will go out of bounds at the 5-yard line. What a fortunate break for Barberton, as just when Haywood made the connection to McKinney, it bounced right off of him and the ball went straight out of bounds. Wow, and it ended up being a 2-yard gain. It's unbelievable. I mean, not only did you not lose possession, most importantly, but you picked up 2 yards out of that. But just not a clean connection that time between Chase Haywood and Markham McKinney. But yet, the Magics maintain possession, 3rd and 2 at the Massillon 5. Tim Starcher will be out wide left. Looks like Ryan Watkins out wide right. Again out of the pistol. Tight end Hornacek moves left. The give is to McKinney. Head down to the 5 and then pushed back. And they're just basically say forward progress right back to the line of scrimmage. It sets up a 4th and 2 from the 5. Now, this is a tough call here for Tony Gatto. You don't want to leave points on the field. And he's going to bring Brown in to kick to attempt a field goal here, I think. This would be, they're going to put this down at the 12-yard line. So it's a 22-yard attempt here as we go under 2 minutes to play in this first quarter. Good snap, good hold. The kick is up. It looked like it might have been partially blocked, but it has the distance, and it is good. With a minute 49 to play in the first quarter, Barberton strikes first on the field goal by Aston Brown. All set up by that Haywood pass to Tim Starcher on 3rd and long. And then Massillon gave an assist with the personal foul penalty, and Barberton able to translate that into points. I'm sure they wanted a touchdown, but considering how close McKinney came to fumbling the football in the playing field, you know, you'll take the field goal and be happy with it with a minute 49 to play in the first quarter. And I think that was the right move for Barberton to not leave points on the field. You're tempted to go for it, but I think against this team in this game, I think they did the right thing. As Massillon will send Terrence Keys and Jaden Ballard back deep to receive. And the one thing that's, again, we're under 2 minutes to play in this first quarter. I mean, you couldn't have scripted this much better, I think, if you're the Magics. You've got the crowd in the game on homecoming. And you're moving the football pretty well. They'll squib it, keep it away from Brown. They'll go on the left side. It's returned to the 40-yard line, out to the 42. Well, I understand you don't want Jaden Ballard, who's got a kick return and a punt return for a touchdown this year, but Massillon's got excellent field position at their own 44-yard line. Maybe you want to squib it down the middle of the field maybe next time? I don't know. All right, first and 10 Tigers. They went three and out there. Actually, I take that back. They didn't go three and out because Keys had gotten a first down run. But after that first down run, it essentially was a three and out. All right, Longwell will operate from the pistol. First and 10 Massillon at their own 43. The give is Keys. He'll cross the 45, take it out to the Massillon 47-yard line. Ryan Watkins made the stop on the play. And also John Jackson again there. It's a gain of four, second down and six. Yeah, Massillon really trying to get Terrence Keys Jr. going early. It's a good strategy. Zion Pfeiffer will be the wingman to the right, two receivers right. Second and four, Keys gets the carry again. Crosses the 50, gets into Magic's territory, and gets the first down. As he'll take it to the Barberton 44-yard line. Keys did a good job just kind of reading his blocks, nothing fancy. Started up to the middle and then shifted left. Alejandro Salazar, by the way, is the left tackle. John Kuth at left guard. Cole Jones at center. Ranger Ellis at right guard. And Terrence Rankel, another one of those D1 prospects, at right tackle. Pistol formation here for Massillon. First and 10 at the Barberton 44. Longwell sets up a bubble screen. It's caught by Ballard at the 40. Ballard will be pushed out of bounds. Inside the Barberton 40, they'll mark him down at the 39-yard line. So Ballard gets his 29th catch of the season. And it'll be second down and five, 45 seconds to play here in the first quarter. 3-0 Barberton. Ballard is only a junior. He's already committed to Ohio State. He's having a tremendous year. 28 catches, 609 yards, and 10 touchdowns. And keep in mind here, as Keys will get the handoff on second down, crosses the 35, crosses the 30, down to the 29, and another Massillon first down at the Barberton 29. Charles Hornacek made the tackle for the Magics. I mean, keep in mind, because Massillon has won so many games lopsided, in the second half, a lot of their key players, like Ballard, like Keys, get basically arrested in the second half, so a lot of their stats are basically based on 2.5 quarters of action per game. As Longwell goes to throw on first down, has time, lofts one deep left towards the end zone. It is caught. Touchdown. Massillon Tigers, it is Jaden Ballard over on the left side. He's able to tightrope his way into the end zone for the touchdown. And Massillon is on the board, and they have taken a 6-3 lead. That's a 29-yard touchdown, Longwell to Ballard. For Aiden Longwell, that's his 17th touchdown pass. And for Mr. Ballard, TD catch, number 11. And I'll tell you, Barberton had great coverage over there on the far side. It was just a beautifully thrown pass by Longwell. As the extra point for Alex Bauer is up, and it is good. Bauer now, by the way, 48 out of 50 in extra points. 16.7 seconds to play in the first quarter, and Massillon, on a shorter field, they come back and put together a 56-yard touchdown drive with the 29-yard TD pass, Longwell to Ballard. But that's how quick Massillon can strike. A couple of Terrence Keys runs, they give you the Ballard bubble screen, and then they throw to Ballard deep. Different side of the field, still beat you. That was, you'll see it tonight when Brian Crane shows the highlights later on. It was just, it was a beautifully thrown football, and it was one-on-one coverage. Ballard was just able to get there first. That's the thing, Ballard's 6'2", 180 pounds, and he's only a junior. He's going to get better. He's going to get a little bigger, stronger, and better before he goes and plays for Ryan Day and the Buckeyes. You look at him already, you say, boy, the tradition of great wide receivers at Ohio State is going to continue. Joe Johnstone, and I believe that's Caleb Vega, both back deep to receive here as this kick will angle towards the right, be caught at the 5-yard line. It's fumbled, picked up at the 10, and down at the 11-yard line. That was McKinney who caught that kickoff but then fumbled it. And well, McKinney was fortunate to get it back, but Barberton in poor field position. They'll start at their own 11-yard line, now trailing 7-3 here in the late stages of this first quarter. for the first, as we said, for the first 11 minutes of this first quarter, I mean, Barberton couldn't have scripted it much better, but Massillon able to strike quickly and get the TD pass from Longwell to Ballard, and they now have a 7-3 lead. Massillon now back to work, or make that Barberton back to work. Massillon's back to work defensively, first and 10 at the 11, and McKinney will be brought down short of the 10-yard line. That will be a loss as Corey Campbell knifed in to make the tackle. That's going to be the final play of the first quarter as we will flip sides and head to quarter number two. And after one quarter of play here at Sharkey Stadium in Barberton, the Massillon Tigers 7 and the Barberton Magics 3. Field goal by Aston Brown, 22 yards out, and that 29-yard TD strike from Longwell to Ballard for Massillon. That is your scoring here tonight. Don't forget, make sure on Monday around noon or so, you log on to WKYC.com. Also, check out our social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, and you can vote on the Week 9, WKYC.com, High School Football Game of the Week. We don't have, we only have one official nominee. We're still working on the other two. I'll drop hints of where we're looking at, but, there will be games, I can tell you, where we look at games this time of year that have the playoff implications and the games that matter for conference championships and such things. And that's certainly our intention as we look ahead to week number 9. Scores here from Mr. Tyler Carey as we get ready for quarter number 2. A lot of games that affect this area. Riverside leading Mayfield in Division 2, Region 5, 7-0. Mayfield is unbeaten heading into tonight. We'll have more scores here coming up in a second, but that's a big, big score early on. We had that game last year, the Beavers and the Wildcats, and I think Riverside won at their place last year. As it'll be a 2nd and 11 after that 1 yard loss by McKinney. Haywood will throw left side, pass caught at the 10, out to the 15, to the 20-yard line, and out of bounds at the 21, very close to the first down. That might have been Cameron Macon here. I'll double check on that ID. No, it was Ryan Watkins was the receiver. No, I take that back. I had it right first. Charles Hornacek was on the catch. Hornacek's 6th catch of the year, and that should be enough for the first down from where they're marking it at the 22, and it will be. Well-conceived play of the time for Barberton is that time Haywood, with that bootleg action, bought him some time, and Hornacek able to cross the field and get that first down. Wasn't sure if that was Watkins because he was out there blocking after Hornacek had made the catch. First down here for the Magics. They'll go back on the ground as McKinney got stood up and then bounced back, and we've got a late flag as McKinney was bounced down right at the line of scrimmage. And we'll check on the flag here. Massillon kind of trying to tighten up the middle of their defense, and they've done a better job here against McKinney, but this penalty is going to be against the Tigers. And it's going to be a personal foul face mask against Massillon. So move the football up to the 37-yard line. And that's going to be another Magic's first down. Boy, the penalties here tonight. You know, Massillon's had a couple of these 15-yard varieties, and it's giving Barberton momentum and now field position. In motion, Joe Johnstone, 1st and 10, Haywood to throw. This time he's being blitzed. He'll roll to the right and looks to run, able to get around a couple of Tiger would-be tacklers and tried to run back to the first down marker, but I think he's going to be marked down back at the 34, so that's probably going to be a loss of 3. It will be. 2nd and 13. Xavier Andrews among those. He's a linebacker on that blitz for Massillon, and Haywood just kind of had to sell out and run. Wanted to throw it away, but really just never had the chance to. 4 wide receivers now for the Magic. 2nd and 13, back at the 34 as Johnstone goes in motion left. Haywood to throw. This time he has time. Goes deep right side for Watkins. Tried to make a one-handed catch, and we got a flag down for a pass interference. Isaiah Roberson was on the shoulder pad of Watkins. And I'll tell you, Ryan almost made that catch anyway. But that's going to be pass interference against Massillon. Another well-thrown football by Chase Haywood. and it gave Watkins a chance to make the catch. Officials will have a powwow here, but I can't see any way this is going to be not a pass interference here, as they're already, I think, starting to mark it off.
That play took place right in front of Barberton bench. Maybe we have
offside. Let's see here. Officials are still conversing here. While we're waiting here for them to mark it off here, more scores. What else we got? It's Hoban now leading Padua 14-0 in the second quarter. Perry, the Panthers, leading Lake 7-0. That's in the second. All right, do we have a call yet here, gentlemen? Let's see. Looks like we have two penalties on the play. Interference against the Tigers. On that we knew. And what else? Is a legal substitution against, or is that a sideline warning? Yeah, I think it's a sideline warning against the Magics. But they'll mark off the penalty and move it up to the 49-yard line of the Magics. Well, it's got Chardon 14-0 over Willoughby South as the Hilltoppers playing some good football right now. Akron East leading Ellett 14-0 in the first. Avon Lake 10-0 over Midview first quarter. Well, wait a minute. Now they're backing it up. So it wasn't a sideline warning. So they just offset it back to the 34-yard line. Okay. So that will nullify what would have been a first down for the Magics. Wadsworth 21-0 over North Royalton in the first quarter. Brecksville 6-0 over Nordonia, 6-3 over Nordonia in the second. And a couple more here. Kent Roosevelt and Revere scoreless in the first. And the Buckeyes and Northwestern will kick off in about 45 minutes out in Evanston. So, penalties offset, second and 13. They'll fake the jet sweep. Hayward got popped right as he tried, as he faked it to Johnstone and then ran right up the middle of the field. Woolyard came in and just leveled him back, say about a half-yard loss, I would think, inside the 34-yard line, and it'll set up that aforementioned third and 13. Boy, but having that pass interference penalty wiped out, essentially, on the offset, really a killer for Barberton. They looked like they were going to have the ball at midfield. Watkins and Johnstone will go out wide left. Starcher and Vega will go to the right. 10:36 to play, first half, 7-3 Massillon here in Barberton. Vega in motion, third and 13. Vega gets it on the jet sweep. He wants to throw, looks left side. Pass is caught. First down, Magics, inside the Massillon 40-yard line. Watkins on the catch, but hold the phone. There's a flag down. Legal motion against Barberton. Wipe out that penalty. Wipe out that game. Vega with a nice throw down the left side of the field. But the penalties continue to be costly for both teams in this first half. So the ball will go back inside the 29-yard line, where it will be now second and 15. Second and 15. McKinney stands to Haywood's right, trips left side. Now McKinney will go out to the right side in a bunch look. Pass caught, Johnstone at the 35, out to the 39-yard line. Got 10 of those yards back. Nice quick strike from Chase Haywood to Joe Johnstone. And it sets up a third down and 5. That's textbook. When you've got a large deficit there, just don't try to get the 15 yards necessarily in one play. Make your life a little easier. Now it's third and 5, and Tony Gatto's play card here is a little bit easier to manage. Vega, Johnstone, and also Starcher out wide left. Watkins wide right. McKinney will go in motion left. Third and 5. Haywood to throw. Pass caught. First down, Ryan Watkins to the 50, breaks away, he's to the 40, he's to the 30, Watkins to the 20, he will score! Touchdown, Barberton Magics! 61 yards on the catch and run, Chase Haywood to Ryan Watkins. That was a bolt of lightning. Once Ryan Watkins got inside the 50-yard line, the foot race is on, and certainly Massillon's got some great defenders and great speed on defense, but Watkins able to win the race to the end zone, and Barberton is back on top, 9-7. Brown in for the extra point. Ball is down. Kick is up on its way, and it's no good. Just a little bit wide left. That'll hold the score at 9-7 Magics with 9:21 to play here in the first half. But I'll tell you, a lot of that, to me, goes back to what they did on that second and 15 play. It was nothing fancy. It was just a quick hitter from Haywood to Johnstone, and it got 10 of those 15 yards back, so all of a sudden you're facing a third and five. And it was a similar type of play. It was just kind of a little slant in for Ryan Watkins, but once he made that initial defender miss, he found the seam down the middle of the field, and that really became the foot race, and the foot race was won by Ryan Watkins. Chase Haywood, by the way, with his 15th touchdown pass of the season. But both these quarterbacks, Haywood and Longwell, throw for high percentages, throw for touchdowns, and their touchdown to interception ratios are both very good. Haywood, 15 touchdowns to 5 interceptions, and Longwell now at 17 touchdowns to 1 interception. And their percentages are both, again, above 65%. I mean, you take that in the NFL, and you go to the Pro Bowl with that. You're an all-pro if you have a completion percentage that high. And the ball just blew off the tee here. Not a ton of wind as I look over at where the flag is, but a little gust there. Yes. Keys and Ballard back deep to receive for the Massillon Tigers. 9-7 Magics. Kick will be angled right, and it'll go out of bounds in the direction of one Mr. Ballard. But I think that's probably as they'll start. That's not a bad strategy either. You know, if you're gonna, you know, you don't want to let Massillon special teams beat you. They're good enough with their offense, and they're certainly good enough with their defense. So it'll be first and 10, and although they may, Massillon might make, they might be making Barberton kick it again. Yeah, no, they're Magics will have to kick off now at their own 35. Yeah, Nate Moore says, okay, listen, why don't you try it again? And this time I'm going to move my guys up to the 20-yard line here and make you try to punch one down the field here. Keys and Ballard have about, let's see, although now I see Zion Pfeiffer moving back a little bit, but there's about 25-yard separation between Massillon's second and third lines, although now the Tigers are backing up a little bit. But it's almost like a dare saying, okay, if you're going to kick it out of bounds, I'm going to move you back until it becomes more or less that I'm going to make you put it in the middle of the field. Now they're going to punch it middle of the field. It takes a bounce at the 32-yard line, picked up at the 35, out to the 40, to the 45, to the 47-yard line. And that was Darian Williams who returned it for the Tigers. And, well, we have a late flag as the teams are starting to move off the field, flag down. And probably in the area where you would expect an unsportsmanlike conduct. Because we were well away from where the tackle was made. At least 5 yards from where the official says dead ball, personal foul, Massillon, personal foul, Barberton. Offset, okay. First down at the 48-yard line of the Tigers. Sometimes I would just say, just blow the whistle, separate the two teams, and let's just play. But I am, the official is trying to maintain order. I get that. All right, here we go. Longwell in the pistol. We'll give the Keys on first down. Keys gets to the 50 into Magic territory, down to the 49-yard line. And Charles Hornacek there on the tackle. And I think we had another flag. The chippiness factor of this game has moved up about 10 notches. I think it was Jaden Ballard and Malik Spragling were spraggling with each other downfield. Personal foul, Massillon. And that's it. This time, it's not an offset. Well, the official thought that by the offsetting penalties on that kickoff scenario would simmer everybody down. Not so much. That is a costly penalty, though, against the Tigers. All the way back to their own 36-yard line. And it's a loss of down. It's going to be a second and 22. 9 minutes and counting to play, second quarter. Barberton 9, Massillon 7. Longwell with Keys behind him in the pistol with three wide receivers. Set the throw. Has time. Looks deep. Left side for Ballard. He's got it inside the 35 and down to the 31. As Spragling was there on the coverage. I think that there's a flag down. They may have gotten Spragling for a pass interference, but it won't matter. That's a first down on a beautiful catch by Jaden Ballard, similar to what we saw on the touchdown. Yeah, it is a defensive pass interference. So penalty declined. They'll mark it at the Barberton 32. First down, Tigers. Ballard, wide right. Andrew Wilson-Lamp, wide left. Double wings for the Tigers. Pistol, Longwell, Gibbs, Keys. Runs to his left, tripped up and down at the 31-yard line. Good surge by the Barberton defense. And again, sophomore nose tackle John Jackson continuing to kind of blow things up in the middle. And then Nick Plasinski and Sonny Fox, two of the linebackers, cleaned it up. 1 yard on the gain, second down and 9 as we approach 8 minutes to play in the first half. Barberton with a two-point lead over undefeated Massillon. Ballard will go wide right this time. Eric Thurman will go slot right. Andrew Wilson-Lamp out wide left. Second down and 9. Back to throw. Longwell flushed. He can run to the 30. Longwell 25. And he'll run it out of bounds to the 21-yard line. And that should be enough for a Massillon first down. And Longwell, again, much like with Haywood, doesn't really run because he doesn't have to run with this offense. But when in need, he's a good athlete, and he recognized the pressure coming in and the good coverage downfield and was able to, as they'll mark it at the 21. They haven't moved the chains yet, but that should be a first down. No, there's a flag down. And yet we had, wait a minute. We have offsetting penalties. It looked like it was, again, the offsetting. Okay, first down. Okay, that's what I wanted to make sure. Another scenario where you had personal foul on each team. I mean, and again, without saying, the officials got to figure out how to get control of this thing here. Austin Brawley now in at wide receiver. He will go out wide to the right. I think Mr. Ballard is getting a quick break on the bench, and now we've got more whistles. And what? I think there was an equipment issue for one of the, Glenn Parker, one of the Magic's linebacker, needed to come out of the game. So he is out, checking his helmet, I think. And we're ready to go. First and 10 at the 21 for the Tigers. They trail by 2. In the backfield now, Zion Pfeiffer. And Pfeiffer will get the carry, and Jackson will put him down at the 19-yard line. Man, John Jackson is a very, very good nose tackle. And he's only a sophomore. He's going to get better. 2-yard pickup by Pfeiffer, though. And it'll be second down and 8. Keys will return for the Massillon Tigers. Pfeiffer, though, averaging about 5 yards a carry, 4.6 yards, 114 yards, and 6 touchdowns on the ground. like to use him in short yardage situations especially. But Keys now will be behind Longwell in the pistol. Three wide receivers for the Tigers. Second and eight. Keys will run to the right, get inside the 15, inside the 10, and will lunge forward for a first down to the 8-yard line. It'll be first and goal Tigers at the Barberton 8. Nick Plusinski, the linebacker for Barberton, was in the backfield, just could not shed his blocker to make the play on Keys. I think he was hoping they were going to call a holding on the play, but that was not the case. First and goal, Massillon at the 8. Three wide receivers for the Tigers. They'll go to Terrence Keys. He'll run to the right. 5-4-3-2-1 and walk in for the touchdown for Massillon. Terrence Keys Jr. with his 14th touchdown of the season. And with 6:46 to play in the first half, Massillon back in the lead, 13-9. Good blocking up front by Massillon. And once Keys got to the line of scrimmage, he just had to make one bouncing move to the outside. And he pretty much knew by the time he was at the 3-yard line he was going to score. Here's the extra point for Bauer. It is up, and it is good. 6:46 to play here in the second quarter. Back and forth we go. Massillon 14, Barberton 9. Now, let's see what Barberton can do offensively here as two teams continue to kind of go back and forth here. The thing with these two Massillon touchdowns, something Barberton's got to figure out here, how to win the field position game, because Massillon, both of those touchdown drives have been when they've started at around their between their 40-yard line and the 50. They started that drive at their own 47, and I know we had the penalties going back and forth a little bit, but the field position certainly has favored the Tigers in this game, but yet Barberton's been able to overcome it. The other thing, of course, in this first half, we've just had a boatload of penalties. I'll be interested to see if we get first half stats here, the total number of penalties, because we've had a ton of them, of course, that have been declined in this first half, too. As Barberton will send Joe Johnstone back deep to receive with Markham McKinney. And Alex Bauer will actually make that Magnus Haynes, the punter, will kick it off. It'll be a short kick. Johnstone runs under it. He's got it at the 15, gets to the 20, and down at the 23-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Magics at that particular point. 6:39 to play in the first half. Barberton, by the way, has two timeouts remaining. Remember, they had to use one on their first possession. But Barberton, offensively, has done a good job in this game of being patient and mixing in short passes and some Markham McKinney runs. And, of course, the home run ball on the catch and run by Ryan Watkins on the touchdown pass from Chase Haywood. At the 23, first and 10 for the Magics. Again, out of the pistol, tight end Hornacek will shift to the right as they will go to Cameron Macon, and Macon's going to be brought down behind the line of scrimmage at the 21 as C.J. Harris, the junior defensive tackle, makes the stop for Massillon. They'll mark it at the 21, and it'll be second down and 12. Macon, like McKinney, is a sophomore. 5'10", 180 pounds, similar size. He averages just under 6 yards per carry. But a pretty good two-headed running back combination with he and McKinney. Second and 12, so under 6 minutes now to play in the first half. As they'll go in the jet sweep, here's Vega. He's going to throw to his left, and this time Watkins can't make the catch. He was on the ground and couldn't make the diving catch. Incomplete. Robbie Page, the free safety over there on coverage. Yeah. Unlike the previous throw from Caleb Vega, that one was a little bit off the mark. And I mean, Watkins still almost made a nice catch, but it's now a third and long coming up here for Barberton. The last thing they want to do is give the ball back to Massillon here with this much time and a 5-point deficit. Macon will stand to the right of Haywood. Third and 12, Barberton from their own 21. Haywood will roll right. Stops, rolls back left. He's tripped up and brought down back at about the 12-yard line. That was Ben Krishbaum who came in to make the sack. And there's a flag down, I'm telling you, about 40 yards away from where the sack happened, and now another flag. One flag down at about the 18-yard line of the Magics and one at midfield. And I'm guessing probably yet another offsetting penalty here. Well, we'll wait and see. Again, just the amount of chippiness between the two teams is unbelievable. Dead ball. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Massillon. Anything else? Dead ball? No, that's it. Just unsportsmanlike against the Tigers. So even though there were two flags down, and I think there's also a sideline warning against Massillon. Well, that's not going to... That's Nate Moore is still about 10 yards on the field, so you can warn him all you want. It doesn't really matter, but unfortunately, it's not an automatic first down, as it's going to be a fourth down and a punting situation here for Barberton. For Krishbaum, that is 2.5 sacks on the year for him. Just a great job of once Haywood kind of made the pivot and turn, he was able to just kind of reach down and lunge and grab him by the ankle and make the sack. It's 4th and 7 for the Magics. And, okay, now they look like they're going to punt. I think Vega is going to do the punting. We've also seen Hayden Macko handling the punting. And one man in single safety for Massillon. High snap. Vega pulls it down. The punt goes off the side of his foot. Off the side of his foot. And it takes a Massillon bounce inside the Barberton 30. And they're going to mark it down near the 25-yard line. That may be a punt of minus 1 yard. Unbelievable. Well, you don't see that every day. I mean, Massillon was coming, but Vega just went off the side of his foot at the 25. Yeah, they had the ball had snapped at the 26, so that's a minus 1 on that punt. So Massillon, with a 5-point lead, will take over at Barberton's 25. From the pistol, the give, Terrence Keyes up the gut, breaks a tackle, gets inside the 20 and down to the 19. Nick Plasinski and Glenn Parker combine on the tackle. That is a gain of 6, 2nd and 4. As we go under 5 minutes to play, Massillon has all their timeouts remaining, by the way, here in this first half. Two receivers right, including Jaden Ballard. Andrew Wilson Lamp out wide left. 2nd and 4. Keyes gets it, this time running to his left. And he will take it down very close to that first down marker near the 15. Let's see where they spot this. They will spot him, I think, a little bit short. And it'll be 3rd down at about 0.5 yard. If you're Massillon here, you can do all sorts of things. Longwell quickly to the line and the pistol. It's 3rd and about 0.5 yard. You've got Anthony Pedro and also Jaden Ballard out wide right. Andrew Wilson Lamp wide left. The give will be Keyes. Sidesteps, breaks a tackle, gets the first down inside the 10, and it'll be 1st and goal for the Tigers at about the 9-yard line. 6 more for Terrence Keyes Jr. That should give him 8 on that pickup. And it'll be 1st and goal at the 8. Pretty good amount of sidestepping and shifting there for Keyes. Started to his right and then saw the hole opening up to his left and made a couple of nice moves. 1st and goal from there. Keyes, again, runs to his left. He's to the 5-4-3-2-1, and he will walk in. Touchdown, Massillon Tigers, Terrence Keyes Jr. And Keyes, after he gets the touchdown, I think he's going to be guilty of unsportsmanlike conduct. He was taunting the crowd and I think also maybe some of the Magics after the touchdown. But Mr. Keyes gets his 15th touchdown of the season, and it's 20-9 Massillon. That's unsportsmanlike conduct indeed of call against the Tigers, so I would assume that would be picked up on the kickoff. 3:34 to play in this first half, and Massillon now with an 11-point lead, although they may have spoke too soon. Are they backing him off here or what? No, I still think they're going to do the unsportsmanlike on the kickoff here. I think it's going to be a standard extra point here for Alex Bauer. So we said Bauer, very good this year with extra points. Ball is down. The kick is up, but Barberton almost got in there. Watkins almost blocked it, but it is good as Bauer now with 50 extra points in 52 attempts here in 2019. 21-9, I should say, Barberton trailing Massillon now with 3:34 to play here in the first half. Terrence Keyes with a pair of touchdowns here in the second quarter to go along with the Longwell to Ballard touchdown pass. Barberton with a field goal and a Haywood to Watkins TD toss. And the Magics now, because of the upcoming penalty, would figure to get some pretty good field position here. And with two timeouts, see if they can come up with something here before halftime. As they've been able to, for the most part, move the football pretty well, talking about Barberton here. So initially they spotted at the 40, but they're going to make Massillon kick off from way back at the 25-yard line. So, as we said, I mean, Barberton would figure to get good field position here to start this drive. As Haynes will tee it up, and, you know, Joe Johnstone and Markham McKinney will stand just shy of their own 20 now to await this kickoff. But it's, again, it's a wonder if Haynes might just kick this thing out of bounds. No, he's going to go middle of the field here, and it'll be Johnstone at the 15-yard line. They'll fake the reverse. Johnstone middle of the field. He's got a seam. He gets to the 40 and brought down at the 44-yard line. Nice tackle in the open field by Isaiah Clark. Otherwise, Joe Johnstone might have busted that all the way. But as we said, good field position here for the Magics near their own 45. Yeah, nice. They faked the reverse. Glenn Parker was over there for Barberton as the kind of the fake man, and Johnstone did a good job keeping his feet. He found the middle of the field in that seam, and only Isaiah Clark prevented a touchdown there. But good field position for the Magics near their own 45. They'll spot it at the Barberton 44. Haywood on first down, on the ground. Here comes McKinney, and he'll cross the 45 and take it out near the 48-yard line. Ben Krishbaum on the tackle with some help from Noah Richards. And gain about 3 on the play, 2nd and 7. So we approach 3 minutes to play here in the first half. 21-9, Massillon leading Barberton. Caleb Vega will be among 3 out wide left. It's Hornacek now, tight end on the right. 2nd and 7. Fake to McKinney. Back to throw Haywood. Pops it over the middle. Pass caught right at the first down marker. And stretching for the first down is Tim Starcher. He'll take it to the Massillon 44. That's a first down completion. And I think we have a Barberton timeout. I don't know. We have officials timeout. Oh, Starcher, after he made the catch, tried to get up and went right back down. And that's why I think the officials sensed what was going on even before everybody else did, including Tony Gatto. And they're going to check on Starcher, and they are stretching out his right leg. Starcher made a terrific lunge there to get that first down. And they'll continue to take a look here.
Tony Gatto was looking. I'm hoping Starcher's okay. Is I just looking down here at Tim, and he was kind of waving his arms at his head coach, and Starcher trying to get up now on his seat here at the 44-yard line. While we have a moment here, it will be first and 10 as looking over at Tony Gatto said something emphatically to his offense here, and just trying to get them motivated here. Starcher is on his feet, and he's able to jog off the field under his own power, so perhaps just a cramp. And it'll be first and 10 for the Magics at that point. 2:47 to play here in the first half. Again, Barberton with two timeouts remaining as they trail 21-9. But the first down completion has them in Massillon territory. As Vega, Cage Lowe will replace Starcher out wide right. Watkins there as well. As they'll go on a bubble screen, Watkins makes the catch at the 45 and will be pushed out of bounds. And a bound at the 42-yard line. Short pickup of two. It'll be second down and 8. Stops the clock with 2:28 to play in the half. Yeah, hard to do a bubble screen against Massillon because of their athleticism on defense. TJ Williams did a good job able to break free from the block and come over and force Watkins out of bounds. This time it'll be trips left side. Starcher is back in there as he and Watkins are over there along with a third receiver. That's Johnstone to throw. His long one looks left side, and the pass is going to be intercepted. It will be picked off at the 27-yard line. Robbie Page on that interception for Massillon. I believe that pass was intended for Johnstone, and a little too much air on that throw for Haywood. He has not been intercepted much this year. It's only his sixth pick, but rotten time for that interception for Barberton as Massillon will take over. First and 10 at their own 27-yard line. That's Page's second interception of the season. And now, Barberton has got to figure out a way to stop this Massillon Express. As plenty of time. Tigers have all their timeouts remaining. And they'll go four wide on this first down play. Keys in the backfield behind quarterback Aiden Longwell. Two receivers to each side from the 27-yard line, first and 10, Longwell. Pressured, coming from the backside, able to get away from the 20. He throws, and that's intercepted by Barberton at the 45, down the right side, to the 30, to the 20, 15, 10, inside the 5, into the end zone. Touchdown, Magics! Charles Hornacek takes the interception back for the touchdown. Charles Hornacek with the interception with 2:03 to play in the first half. It makes it 21-15. So just when we talked a moment ago about the quarterbacks having great touchdown to interception ratios on back-to-back plays, Haywood picked off by Maslin's Robbie Page, and then Charles Hornacek picks off Aiden Longwell and takes it back. Does a nice tightrope walk down the right sideline and takes it in for 6. Extra point for Barberton as Brown tries to cut into this deficit a little bit more. Ball is down, kick is up, on its way, and it's good. 2:03 to play, first half. Massillon 21, Barberton 16. Unbelievable. And by the way, how about this? At halftime, Hoban 14, according to Mark Munch Bishop, Akron Hoban, Archbishop Hoban 14, Padua 6. Keep in mind, hey, Padua just knocked off a couple weeks ago. They went over to NDCL and beat the Lions, which surprised the heck out of a lot of people. And they're playing Hoban very well. 14-6 at halftime. That's amazing. Wait till I tell Munch.
similar situation in this game. 21-16, Massillon getting all they can handle. They lead Barberton by six, but unbelievable. Barberton gets that pick six by Hornacek. That's text. Massillon. About that. High school football, man. You never know. You never know. All right. Magic's to kick off. And Keys and Ballard back deep to receive. And Ballard's going to have an opportunity here at the three. He's got a kick return for a touchdown this season. Runs to his right at the 15. Has a hole to the 30. Oh, he's tripped up as he crosses the 30 down to the 34-yard line. I think that was Cage Lowe who made a touchdown-saving tackle there. And that fires up the pick six, and then the tackle by Lowe, who got Ballard there, fires up the Magic's crowd a little bit more. But, man, you're playing, you just could tell with Ballard, man, you're playing with fire if you are kicking off to him. If he breaks through that tackle, he's gone with his speed. From the 34, first and 10 Tigers, with a minute 55 to go before halftime. Massillon 21, Barberton 16. It's been a dandy of a first half. Keys gets the carry to the 40, breaks to the 45, 50 into Barberton territory and down at the Magic's 47. Keys, one tackle away from breaking it for six. Nick Plasinski on that touchdown-saving tackle for the Magics. Minute 49 as the clock stops to move the chains. First half. Two receivers left, two to the right. Keys behind quarterback Aiden Longwell. We're going to have a timeout here. Is it a timeout Barberton or an official's timeout here? I don't know. Reset the play clock here. And they wind the game clock, and now it's going to be a Magic's timeout. Okay. There's not even a timeout can be normal here tonight. 21-16, Massillon leading Barberton with a minute 42 to go before halftime. And Mark Bunch-Bishop just tells me, yeah, you got a game too. That's exactly right. Quite a first half tonight here in Barberton. Massillon getting touchdowns, a pair of TD runs from Terrence Keys Jr. and an Aiden Longwell to Jaden Ballard touchdown pass. Barberton, a few moments ago with the pick six from Charles Hornacek, they have also gotten a touchdown pass, a 61-yard catch and run, Chase Haywood to Ryan Watkins, and a field goal by Eston Brown. All over the place tonight here. First and 10, Tigers, as we go back to action from the Barberton 47. Austin Brawley and Anthony Pedro will go out wide right. Wilson Lamp and Ballard wide left. It'll be Keys getting the carry again to the 45 and down to the 40. Gain of about seven on first down, and the scoreboard just went out. And now it's back in. Okay. That's always good. All of a sudden, all the lights on the scoreboard go out. 125 and counting. Second and three, Massillon. They'll keep it going here with Keys. Runs to his right, shifts back left, gets the first down, and gets put down at the 36. Needed three, got four. First down, Tigers. With a minute 17, they'll stop the clock to move the chains. Massillon being very economical. They're running the football, but they're able to get the clock where they want it. They have all their timeouts remaining. Barberton has one remaining. Longwell wants to throw. The lefty looks, fires deep towards the end zone, has a man there, diving attempt, and it's incomplete to Anthony Pedro. Actually, take that back. That was Austin Brawley, number 80, not number 10, on that dive attempt. And it's incomplete. Charles Hornacek back on the coverage, second and 10. Clock stops with a minute 7 to go. Brawley really sold out to try to make that catch. Brawley only 5'8", 135 pounds. He's a sophomore, but they like to go to him on those long plays. And we've got another timeout. Barberton's going to use their final timeout. And Tony Gatto wasn't happy that he had to use it, but somebody was out of position. And so they'll take the timeout with 107 to play before halftime. Yeah, Barberton struggled so much last week against Aurora, especially on offense against Aurora's terrific defense. But tonight, I mean, the Magics really came out. And homecoming, you've got Massillon here. I mean, this is a great setting anyway for a game. But I mean, you can just tell there's something different about the Magics early on tonight, and they have given Massillon everything they've handled. That's one thing you talk to people who follow this Tiger team. The one thing Massillon hasn't been much this year is challenged. For this first half, they've been challenged. Second down, second and 10. Longwell looks, throws. Ballard's got it in space at the 35. He goes to the 30, cuts upfield at the 20. And let's say they're going to mark him out of bounds, I think, shy of the 20 at about the 23. But that's a gain of 13 on second and 10. And a first down on that catch to Jaden Ballard. First time we've seen them do that with Ballard tonight in space like that. Longwell gets his team quickly to the line. They'll mark it at the 23 of the Magics. Ballard and Pedro wide right. Hodges and Wilson Lamp wide left. Longwell gives Keys up the middle. Big hole to the 15, to the 10, inside the 5. And Terrence Keys Jr. will take it down right out the 2-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Tigers with 52 seconds to play before halftime. And Massillon will take a timeout and get themselves set up with a goal-to-go situation. What, Keys is so elusive. And when he makes his first cut, he's still so dangerous because he's got great field vision. You may think he's heading left, and he makes a couple of nice moves to the right, and you're hugging air. And, you know, it's funny. It's when you talk about Massillon, it's so much conversation has been about Longwell and this wide receiver core, especially Wilson Lamp and Ballard. But, I mean, Terrence Keys Jr. is on his way to a 1,000-yard-plus season running the football, and he's already got 15 touchdowns. And I would imagine he's going to get an opportunity here for number 16 in a few moments. He's as good as a running back as we've seen anywhere in Northeast Ohio this year. We've been all over the place. All right, first and goal for Massillon at the Barberton 2. Keys stands behind quarterback Aiden Longwell. And before we can run a play, flag down, and a penalty looks like it can be called, I think, an encroachment or an offsides against Barberton. Somebody was lined up, I think, in the neutral zone. So they'll mark it ever so closer to the end zone now. It'll be first and goal at the 1. Still out of the pistol. Longwell gives. Keys runs to his left. Cuts inside. And then fights his way in. Touchdown, Massillon Tigers. Terrence Keys Jr. with his 16th touchdown of the year. And Massillon's lead now at 27-16. Keys this time thought better of taunting the Barberton fans and went over to rouse up the Massillon fans. And the visiting bleachers are jam-packed with Massillon fans, as you could imagine. Extra point is up for Bauer, and it is good. 28-16. Tigers back to a 12-point lead with 46.7 seconds to go before halftime. Pretty good response, though, for Massillon after the pick six by Hornacek. Yes. Put together a nice drive there, mostly with the legs of Terrence Keys Jr. And, you know, you might say, well, geez, you know, Dino, you mentioned all the wide receivers and the talent that Massillon has, but one thing you have to consider when you look at Massillon is their offensive line. Salazar is 250 pounds. Kuth, 320. Jones at center, 305. Ells, 290. Rankle, 265. That's a lot of beef. And really, with the exception of John Jackson, there's not a lot of size on Barberton's defensive line. There's speed, there's athleticism, there's talent, but in terms of just physicality and size, it favors Massillon. And they've wanted to own the line of scrimmage tonight with Terrence Keyes Jr., and for the most part, they've been very successful doing that. Haynes will kick off. Johnstone, Kenny back deep to receive, and it's going to be Johnstone at the 4. He'll run to the 10 and reverses his field out to the 15, still on his feet, and knocked out of bounds near the 20-yard line. Not bad effort there. Joe Johnstone had to run a long way to get a net 16-yard return, but first and 10 for the Magics there. And in this situation, you probably wouldn't expect a whole lot here from Barberton. Down 12 before halftime, knowing, of course, that Massillon's going to get the ball first to start the second half, but Barberton, without timeouts, ball just around, just shy of the 20-yard line. One would think the prudent thing to do would be just basically run it in the middle and head to the locker room here, but we'll see if that's what Tony Gatto wants to do. Pistol look here for the Magics, first and 10, and we got a flag down here before we can do anything. False start against Barberton. I have no idea where it was, but okay. So that'll back it up just inside of the 15-yard line and make it first and 15. I think that's very strange. It just looked like everybody was watching the Magics. It looked like everybody was set, but apparently not. 37.6 seconds to play in the first half. Massillon 28, Barberton 16. First and 15 on the ground, and spinning is McKinney to the 17-yard line, and then he's put down at that particular point by Luke Murphy, and Massillon will take a timeout. So Nate Moore thinking, you know, if I can get the clock down to a point where I make Barberton punt, maybe I can get the ball into Jaden Ballard's hand one more time here before halftime. It'll be second and 12. After the 3-yard pickup from Markham McKinney. This has been, we had a very fast-moving first quarter, but with all of the scores and the penalty flags and timeouts, the second quarter has kind of moved to a crawling pace here in Barberton. At Rudy Sharkey Stadium. We mentioned before the game started, these two teams haven't played each other since 1995 when they played at the old Rubber Bowl, and Massillon won that game 22-20. At one point, this was a pretty good rivalry. They had met 45 times, or 44 previous times before that 1995 matchup, but then there was a 24-year gap since then. Now, Barberton's going to go to a kneel-down formation here. And Haywood will kneel it down with 28, 27 seconds. And Massillon will burn another timeout here. 26 seconds now to play. So it'll be a loss back to about the 16-yard line. And third and long. But, yeah, again, the strategy here for Nate Moore is, look, I want you to kick it, and I'm going to give my punt returner, whether they put Ballard back there or Pedro or whoever else, and give my guys an opportunity to see if we can't get one more big play here before halftime. So that's where that logic comes from. It's been a lot of fun here, though, tonight in Barberton. Right from the get-go, you get, like I said, there was a vibe in the stadium. It's when you haven't played a team for 24 years, and it's Massillon with all the pageantry and all the history. There's just a different feel about it. As Haywood on third down will hit a knee here, 23-22. Massillon's out of timeouts here, so Let's see, 16. No, they haven't wound the play clock yet. That'll do it for the first half. That Massillon tried. But that will take us to halftime, where the Massillon Tigers at 7-0 on the season lead the Barberton Magics, who are 5-2. 28-16 is your score. You're in for a treat. Two tremendous bands will entertain you at halftime. Massillon up first, followed by Barberton. We'll let you enjoy that and be back with get some first half numbers, get you ready for the second half in a few moments. Enjoy halftime, everyone. Again, 28-16, Massillon leading Barberton in our WKYC.com High School Football Game of the Week. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the bands here at halftime. As we welcome you back up to the press box here of Rudy Sharkey Stadium, I'm Dave DeNatale at the half. Barberton trailing Massillon 28-16 in our WKYC.com High School Football Game of the Week. Happy to have so many of you, I'm sure, not just around the area, but around the country and beyond, listening in tonight. Here is a lot of Massillon Tiger faithful I know around the country, and we're happy to have so many with us here. We'll get some scores here, but as we resume action, first half numbers shaped out like this. The number we were all looking at up here, it was the number of penalties in the first half, and not surprisingly, there were a lot. For Massillon, they were penalized 7 times for 98 yards in that first half. Barberton, 8 penalties for 50 yards. The Magics won in a big category in time of possession, which they needed to do, although I think that tightened up a little bit in the second half. Barberton held the ball 15 and a half minutes, 15:34 to Massillon's 8:26. Total yards in that first half, Massillon ran 28 plays for 227 total yards. Barberton, 30 plays for 151. First downs, 12 for the Tigers, 8 for the Magics. And that pretty much was how that played out. As far as individual stats, let's start first with the Tigers. Terrence Keyes Jr., 18 carries for 135 yards and 3 touchdowns in the first half. Just dazzling. And I would imagine as the game continues to be a tight, close game, if it stays like this, we'll see a lot more of Keyes, and they're going to feed him and let him and that offensive line try to really control the line of scrimmage for the remainder of the football game. As far as throwing the football, Aiden Longwell, 4 of 8 for 80 yards, 1 touchdown. He was intercepted once. That was the pick 6 from Charles Hornacek that he took back. 52 yards was the official call on that touchdown return. Receiving, Jaden Ballard, the only Tiger to catch passes tonight, 4 catches for 80 yards and a touchdown, including that 30-yarder was what the official call was. As far as Barberton, Chase Haywood, 6 of 7 passing for 124 yards, 1 touchdown, and 1 interception. He's also sacked one time. Ryan Watkins, 2 catches for 62 yards, 60 of those coming on that catch-and-run touchdown that came in the second quarter. Tim Starcher, 2 catches for 39 yards. Hornacek had 1 catch for 12 yards. Johnstone, 1 for 11. And also Markham McKinney, 13 carries for 33 yards. His longest was 15. And really just tough sledding for Markham after the first possession or two of that first half, of the first quarter, really. And after that, just tough sledding as Massillon's defensive line really did a good job tightening up. But they're going to need McKinney at the very least to offer the threat of a run in the second half. It can't just be put Haywood back and let him throw, because otherwise you can pin your ears back and really come after him. So as far as the scoring and how things played itself out here, and we've got a bunch of scores that are coming in from Tyler Carey, so we'll pass those to you here in just a second. Barberton struck first. They went on a 60-yard drive that ate 10 plays, ate up 6 minutes off the clock. That is exactly what they want to do tonight. And Eston Brown had a 22-yard field goal to make it 3-0 for Magics. Now, right before halftime, Massillon came back on a 56-yard drive, 5 plays, and got the 30-yard touchdown pass from Longwell to Ballard to go on top 7-3. But Barberton would strike in the second quarter as they would go 89 yards in 7 plays, took 2:51 off the clock. It was a 60-yard touchdown pass from Haywood to Watkins to go up top 9-7. Extra point was not good. Terrence Keyes with a pair of touchdown runs, one from 7 yards out, one from 8 yards out, put Massillon up 21-9. It looked like the Tigers were going to stretch out that lead after they got the interception that was by Robbie Page with just over 2 minutes to play in the first half. You thought, boy, Masson's going to come down and strike and maybe put the game out of reach. But Charles Hornacek, on the very next play after the Page interception, picked off Longwell, took it back 52 yards for the touchdown to cut the gap to 21-16 with 2:03 to go before halftime. But Massillon then struck on a 66-yard touchdown drive, 7 plays, most of it done from Terrence Keyes, and he took it in from 1 yard out to make it 28-16. And that's where we stand as we look ahead here towards the second half. As far as scores from around the region, Mayfield and Riverside are all knotted up at 14 apiece as that game is now in the third quarter. Also in the third quarter, we mentioned Hoban and Padua. The Bruins playing Hoban tough, but the Knights have scored again. They lead 21-6 now in the third quarter. Perry leading Lake 23-7 in the third quarter. Chardon shutting out Willoughby South 28-0 in the third quarter. I mean, we just saw South a couple of weeks ago. A good football team. Rebels are very good. I came away very impressed with them. But they lost to Kenston, and now tonight getting a couple of weeks ago, and then tonight getting shut out by Chardon. And Mitch Hewitt has the Hilltoppers playing really well right now. Also playing well, Matt Kostelnik's Avon Lake Shoreman. They're shutting out Midview 30-0 in the third quarter. Wandsworth leading North Royalton 38-19 in the third. Brecksville over Nordonia 32-16 third quarter. And Kent Roosevelt leading Revere 14-7. That is in quarter number three and just getting underway in Evanston, Ohio State, already out to a quick 7-0 lead over Northwestern. All right, Tyler Carey is your man for all the scores. Make sure you're catching our page at WKYC.com. As we'll keep you updated on all the high school games throughout the evening. Remember, Monday at noon, you can log on to WKYC.com, the 3 News app, and also on our social media platforms. We will be offering up 3 more games for you, our nominees for Week 9, our high school football game of the week. I can tell you one of the 3 will be, you just heard me mention Revere a minute ago, playing Kent Roosevelt tonight. We'll stay in that suburban league with Revere. They will be at Aurora next Friday night at Veterans Stadium. That will be one of the 3 nominees for the game of the week. We'll let you know the other 2 as we get our confirmations, and we'll certainly have them by Monday at noon. And you can then vote for the next 48 hours or so after that, and we'll announce where we're going then Wednesday at 5 o'clock on Facebook Live and YouTube. Tyler Carey and yours truly will make the announcement. I'll give you hints, though. We're looking to stay east in addition to Aurora. Maybe one in Lake County and one in Summit County. As Barberton trying an onside kick to start the second half, but it's going to be fielded by Massillon at the 49-yard line. That was a good job by Massillon's Austin Brawley to recover and be ready for that onside kick. And Massillon will start at their own 48-yard line. Now, they had started the second half in similar, the first half, I should say, a couple of their drives in similar situations. So I don't think it totally surprised them, but Massillon was ready for it. And they'll strike now first and 10 near midfield. Go right back to Terrence Keyes. He'll cross midfield and take it down to the Magic's 49-yard line. So it gets about 3 on the play. Sonny Fox, the linebacker, makes the tackle for the Magic's. It'll be second down and 8. Also, Tim Starcher from his safety spot helping out for Barberton. We said Terrence Keyes Jr. with a mega first half, 135 yards and 3 touchdowns. Second and about 8. Keyes again running right, breaks a tackle, breaks another tackle, and dives forward close to the first down as they'll mark him just inside the Barberton 43. And let's see where they're going to move the stick here. Did he get it? No. So it'll be about third, a little less than a yard. Third and about 2 feet. Just getting underway here in the third quarter. Massillon 28, Barberton 16. I'm Dave DeNatale. Happy to have you with us here on our WKYC.com high school football game of the week. Third and less than a yard. Here comes Keyes, and he's going to be stacked up, but move the pile with those legs of his, cranking ahead for the first down at the 41-yard line. John Jackson had him. He was trying to shed a blocker, but he had Keyes. But I think between blocker and Keyes, just kind of chopping those feet and moving those legs, able to get that first down. It's a fine piece of running by Terrence Keyes. You understand when you watch him, you see why Division I schools are looking at him, and he's got a number of offers. He's very, very talented. 2 receivers left, including Jaden Ballard, first and 10, and Massillon wants to throw. Longwell pressured all the way back to his own 45 and just throws it away, incomplete. Closest man to the football was fullback Zion Pfeiffer. But good rush that time. Kenyandra Turner, the junior defensive end, was in there with Sonny Fox for the Magics. It'll be second and 10 for the Tigers. Massillon will go four wide now, and so they're bringing an extra wide receiver. Pedro comes in, and Pfeiffer comes out on second down and 10. Wilson Lamp and Hodges out to the right. Ballard and Pedro out wide left. And now in motion goes Jerron Hodges. Second and 10. Terrence Keyes will get the handoff, runs left, follows his blocks, and will take it inside the 40 down to about the 38-yard line. Nick Plasinski made a tackle and got up and pumped his fists. I think he was just excited to bring him down. Keyes picks up about four on the gain, and it'll be third and 6. So we go under 10 minutes to play here in the third quarter. See what Nate Moore wants to do here for the Tigers. Again, with four wides, Keyes stands just behind Longwell, who wants to throw on third and 6 over the middle. Pass caught. Wilson Lamp has it inside the 30. Keeps his feet chopping, and he'll get the first down to the 29-yard line. First catch of the night for junior wideout Andrew Wilson Lamp. His 26th catch of the year, and it's a first down for the Tigers at the Magic's 29. Yeah, both Andrew Wilson Lamp and Jaden Ballard are only juniors. I mean, they're going to be back, and they're going to continue to haunt secondaries around Northeast Ohio and beyond for another season. Ball now at the Barberton 29. In motion is Pfeiffer. Ball is loose and on that shotgun snap, and Keyes has to go and pounce on it all the way back to the 42-yard line of Barberton. That's a loss of 13. Ooh. Bad center quarterback exchange there on the shotgun snap. And that is going to bring up a second and 23. They'll stay with the same look, the pistol formation. Wilson Lamp out wide right. Pedro and Ballard out wide left. Pfeiffer in at tight end as he goes wing left. Second and 23. Pressure coming to throw. Deep right side for Wilson Lamp. He makes the catch. Inside the 10-yard line, they'll mark him at the 9. It will be first and goal on a second and 23. Brilliant pass and catch. Aiden Longwell to Andrew Wilson Lamp. Wow. Just like the touchdown, one-on-one coverage, good coverage, but better throw and a terrific catch. Wow. 34 yards on that pass play. Keyes on first and goal from the 8 will be brought down after about a gain of 1. And so lunge ahead to about the 7-yard line. It'll be second and goal at that particular point. Charles Hornacek made the tackle for the Magics. 8:15 to play here in the third quarter. Massillon with a second and goal from the 7, already leading it 28-16. Three receivers for the Tigers. Two men shift in motion to the right. Keyes again. Stutter steps. Cuts back. Runs left. Inside the 5. Still on his feet. Takes it down near the 1-yard line. So tough to bring down just when you think you have him. Terrence Keyes Jr. just continues to make people miss. Third and goal at the 1. Wow. Man, I tell you, Barberton thought they had Terrence Keyes down at the 5-yard line. Third and goal from the 1. Keyes will get it. Keyes will go into the end zone. Touchdown, Massillon Tigers. 17th touchdown of the season. Fourth touchdown on the night for Terrence Keyes Jr. And Massillon with their largest lead of the game at 34-16 with 7:24 to play here in the third quarter. A time sustained. I mean, Massillon usually strikes quick. That was about a 4.5-minute drive. Here's the extra point for Alex Bauer. It's up, and it is good. 35-16. Tigers open up now a three-possession lead on Barberton. I mean, at one point it was 21-16 with 2 minutes to go before halftime. That's how much the kind of the cycle changed after the pick six. Massillon gets the touchdown before halftime, and then they come right out, take that second half kickoff down. As again, Barberton tried the onside kick to try to get the football, maybe, you know, confuse Massillon there a little bit, but Tigers get a 53-yard touchdown drive and now have a 19-point lead. Plenty of time, though. Still 7:24 to go here in the third quarter. But let's see. We'll see what Barberton does here when they get the football back.
Welcome back to Barberton, 35-16 Tigers over the
Magic. As Johnstone and Watkins will go back deep to receive. I see Watkins back there. I see Johnstone back there. And also looks like Malik Spragling is back there as well. As the kick will go to Johnstone. He makes the catch at the 6. To his left at the 20. And Johnstone will take it forward. And good return. Crosses the 30. We'll see where he spotted. Near the 35-yard line. I think everybody from Massillon thought he was out of bounds. Closer to the 30. And Joe Johnstone with a nice return there for the Magics. And they will indeed spot it. Just a little bit shy of the 35-yard line. So now, I mean, let's see where they're going to put this down. Not as close to the 35 as I thought. They'll say he went out of bounds just shy of the 32. But, again, good return nonetheless for Joe Johnstone, the senior. But the Magics now, as we said, with a three-possession deficit, essentially, I mean, this is... You got to score with Massillon to stay with Massillon. That's where we're at right now. And they need to come out and respond here. On first down, they'll go on the ground. And it's Macon. Actually, no, make that McKinney. And McKinney is brought down after about a 2-yard gain to the 34-yard line. Robbie Page, who had an interception earlier in this game, came up to make the tackle. It'll be second down. And we'll call it 8. 6:52 to play in the third quarter. Caleb Vega will go out wide left. Tim Starcher will join him out there. And then you've got Ryan Watkins going out to the right. Massillon 35, Barberton 16. Second down and a long 7, closer to 8. They'll do a reverse. Here comes Watkins running left, trying to get a block, isn't there. And a good job by Robbie Page to stay with it and bring him down right at the line of scrimmage. That was textbook by the senior free safety. Yeah, Tim Starcher just was trying to block for his teammate, and Robbie Page just did a brilliant job of shedding it and staying there and making the stop. Charles Hornacek will check in to play tight end here on third down and... Yeah, it's really now. It's third and 8. They say 7, but it's closer to 8. They got to get to the 42-yard line. Shotgun here for Chase Haywood on third and long. Looks, throws. Starcher at the 35 and tripped up at about the 37-yard line by Isaiah Roberson in the corner. That play, unfortunately, doesn't give your wide receiver a lot of chance to break a tackle and go because it took so long for that pass to get there. And Roberson made a terrific tackle. Only a gain of about 3. It's 4th and 4. And Tony Gatto understands now. I mean, he's got to go for it. Because, again, you have to score with Massillon. And you're going to need some stops, too. Drake Steffen goes out wide left. 2 receivers right. 4th and 4 for Barberton near their own 37. Haywood to throw. Pass is caught at the 45-yard line. Caleb Vega has it. That's a first down for the Magics. What perfect call right there. Quick drop for Chase Haywood. And just a little kind of a slant in there for Caleb Vega. And it's a first down for the Magics. Under 5 minutes to play in the third quarter, but they keep the chains moving now and first down. Again, Steffen, who, by the way, is 6'4". Just keep in mind, they may He'll be matched up against 6 foot Anthony Pedro. First and 10 Magics at the 45. Fake handoff. Haywood to throw. Has time. Now flushed. Rolls. Going to tuck and run. And it'll be run out of bounds by Corey Campbell and also by Ben Krishbaum. Probably, if he's lucky, he got back to the line of scrimmage. But I think they're going to mark it for a loss of about one. It'll be second down and 11. Haywood on the play fake to McKinney had time, but then it closed quickly. And you had Ethan Tobin and Corey Campbell kind of closing in the ends and Krishbaum chasing him. Second and 11 for the Magics. 4:18 to play here in the third quarter. It's a 19-point lead for Massillon. Barberton on a second and long. Haywood will go on a quarterback draw to the 45, to the 50. First down to the 45 and down to the Tiger 43. Well-conceived quarterback draw that time by the Barberton Magics, and Chase Haywood gets the first down on the pickup. Yeah, I tell you, for Barberton, again, that's if you look at their, you know, the scouting report, that's not something you would have expected to see. But Haywood's a good athlete, and it opened up very nicely on the inside in the middle for him, and he gets the first down. Joe Johnstone checks in. He'll go out wide left, trips left side for the Magic's one receiver right. And now McKinney moves over left. Back to throw Haywood. Steps up. In trouble. Going to tuck and run. He's got room to the 40, to the 35, and out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Gain of about 8 for Chase Haywood. Well, sometimes you have it by design. Sometimes you improvise. But they're moving the football. It's a first down with 3:42 to go here in the third. 8-yard pickup for Chase Haywood. Drake Steffen and Joe Johnstone will go out wide right. Tim Starcher and Caleb Vega out wide left. Second and 2 for the Magics at the Massillon 35. McKinney stands to the left of Chase Haywood. Haywood from the shotgun. Johnstone in motion. Fake to him. Haywood will keep it, and he'll run forward to the 34. Going to be a little bit short of the first down. Corey Campbell made the tackle for the Tigers. Third down and about a yard. That time the Tigers were ready for Chase Haywood. All sorts of substitutions here for the Magics. Gavin, they're going to bring two tight ends in, both Charles Hornacek and Gavin Gillimore. Gavin Gallimore is 6'4", 215 pounds. I mean, on this team, you could put him on the offensive line. And before the Magics can run the play, I think they're going to use a timeout and talk about it on this third and one. They will. I think they had Chase. On that play, Chase, before the timeout, it looked like Chase Haywood was going to move out to a receiver spot on that left side. So they'll take the timeout with 3 minutes exactly to play in the third quarter. Massillon leading Barberton 35-16. Massillon looking to go to 8-0 and stay atop the Division II region number 6 rankings. Barberton came into tonight ranked number 9. And remember, the top 8 get in when we start the playoffs 3 weeks from tonight. Can you believe that, by the way, 3 weeks from tonight? Haywood, the quarterback, is out wide left. So it's a wildcat here. Caleb Vega will get the shotgun snap. He's got it. He looks to throw. Vega will pop it, and the pass is dropped at the 25-yard line, looking for tight end Gavin Gallimore, and just couldn't handle it. It's kind of like a wounded duck there, but that's still a pass that I think Gallimore probably will look back and say, I should have caught. It's now 4th and 1 yard. And again, it's going to be the same look here. You're going to have Haywood go out wide left, and Vega will get the snap. He'll keep it on the Wildcat, and he will get, from where they're going to mark it, he'll get the first down as they'll mark it at about the 32-yard line. Only needed 1, and he got about 2, so that's a first down for the Magics. Markham McKinney will check back in, and I would suspect that probably Chase Haywood will check back in at quarterback, but good job there by Caleb Vega as they get the first down. We're under 3 minutes now to play here in the third. Barberton trailing by 19. So trying to get this back to a two-possession deficit before we head to the fourth quarter. Give themselves some kind of a shot to stick in this ball game as Haywood looks to throw. Looking deep for Watkins, right side. Oh, makes a great catch. Inside the five at the two-yard line and out of bounds. It'll be first and goal. Heck of a catch by Ryan Watkins. And by the by, that's a great throw by Chase Haywood. First and goal, Magics. Wow. I think it was Robbie Page was on coverage, and there was nothing wrong with it. It was step for step. But that throw was just kind of to the outside, and Watkins went over and made a terrific catch. Ball spotted at the two. It'll be first and goal. Barberton is not going without a fight here tonight. Again, they'll go to that same Wildcat look. Vega in the backfield. Haywood out wide left. First and goal from the two. Vega keeps it. Little student body right, but that hole closes quickly, and everybody will go down right about at the line of scrimmage. And it'll be second and goal from there. Let's see where they officially spot this football. They may actually move it back to the three here. Took a little bit. Also, there's an injured Massillon Tiger on the field. There was quite a scrum there on that Wildcat play trying to bring down Vega. And the injured Tiger is down on his stomach. So they will tend to the injured player. It's a loss of one, so it's going to be second and goal from the three when we resume action here. 2:02 to go in this third quarter. You know, this game has had so many twists and turns. We had so many possessions from each team in the second quarter. In this third quarter, Massillon took the football, and what ended up essentially being a short field, they went in and got the touchdown with about 7 minutes to go, and this Barberton drive is eating up about 5 minutes off the clock here, and they're poised to score with 2:02 to go in the third quarter here. You can play this game so many different ways. It's pretty amazing. As we check out our scoreboard here, our first final of the night belongs to the Charton Hilltoppers. They beat Willoughby South tonight 42-0. So that's Division 3, Region 9, and that will help Charton's call. I mean, Charton beating Kenston last week obviously was huge for their playoff hopes, but this will help them as well. Now, you want to go play at Charton first week of the playoffs? I wouldn't. And that's the thing now, like a team like Kenston, I mean, they may end up having to be on a road team to start the playoffs. They still have work to do, but that's interesting how that might shape out. Also, a final tonight, Avon Lake beating Midview 32-0. Keep in mind, Midview, the Middies, just beat Olmsted Falls last week, which was a big upset, knocked O Falls from the ranks of the unbeaten. And Avon Lake, since that opening night loss to Avon, I think it was 12-7 or 16-12, or it was a close game, as the injured Massillon Tiger is being helped off the field. I'll try and see who the young man is in a second. I'm shielded by the training staff. But Avon Lake, Matt Kostelnik's team is playing as well as anybody on the west side of Cleveland right now. And, you know, they will be a tough out for anybody in Division II Region 6. As we resume action here, it's going to be second and goal from the 3 yard line. Again, I'm trying to see who the injured Massillon player is. I'm not 100% sure who it is. I thought it might have been Corey Campbell, but I can't tell. But we are set to resume action here on second down and goal. And again, it's going to be the same look. Vega in the backfield with Cameron Macon to his right. Haywood, the quarterback, out wide left. Second and goal. Vega keeps and nowhere to go. On a second effort, he got back to the line of scrimmage, and that's really about it. It's interesting. We haven't seen them run this Wildcat until this sequence. And again, I don't want to sound like I'm criticizing Tony Gatto, but I wouldn't want to take the ball out of the hands of Chase Haywood. Third and goal. Vega will keep again. Out of the Wildcat, not going to get to the goal line. He'll be pushed back after he got inside the two, and it's going to set up a fourth and goal. And there's going to be also a penalty to make matters worse, a penalty against Barberton, I think, an illegal motion. Nate Moore running on the field to see what his options are, and I think he's going to decline the penalty. Minute 24 to play in the third. That penalty will indeed be declined. So it's going to be fourth down and goal at the two. The reason why I'm saying you take the ball out of the hands of Chase Haywood, one of the things that has worked really well tonight for the Magics has been that short, quick passing. And now all of a sudden, now they'll have their base offense back in. Watkins back in, Johnstone back in. So, yeah, we are not going to see a whole lot of trickeration, I don't think, on this particular play. Trips left, one receiver right. Fourth and goal, Barberton at the two. Tony Gatto did about a 25-yard sprint down the right sideline, and he'll get a timeout for the Magic, so he'll have one more remaining. I mean, I'm not kidding. When I say it was a 20-yard sprint, he went from the 20-yard line to about the 5-yard line to get the officials' attention. So it's going to be fourth and goal at the 2-yard line as Barberton. Yeah, you get a touchdown here. The very least, you'd put it to 35-22. You'd have it down to a 13-point deficit. Then decide if you want to kick the extra point or try to go for two with 57 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Looks like they're going to also bring in Charles Hornacek to play tight end as an extra blocker, perhaps. All right, they break up the sideline huddle. Watkins will move out wide to the left. And you've got two receivers bunched up to the right, Stefan and Starcher. Fourth and goal, Barberton at the two. Out of the pistol, Haywood, fake handoff, bootleg action, rolling left, in trouble, cuts back right, all the way back to the 15, throws to the end zone. It is intercepted in the end zone. Intercepted as Caden Woolard has the interception. Oh, wait a minute. We've got a flag down in the back of the end zone here. Stand by. This may have come, though, after the pick here. Let's see what the officials say. Massillon is still celebrating. It looks like it's penalty against Barberton anyway here. Now they're going to try it again. Yeah, penalty is against Barberton. It's waved off, and it will be first and 10 for the Tigers, at the 20-yard line. A nice interception by Woolard. You love the play call there because, you know, Haywood was rolling left on the bootleg, and it looked like he was going to have something there, but it closed quickly. Tigers did a good job in coverage, and then the pressure forced Haywood to have to pivot and roll to his right and then just get rid of it for dear life. He did have, there were some purple jerseys there, but Woolard gets his second interception of the season. And it's first and 10 Massillon now at their own 20. Looking to maybe throw a knockout punch here late in this third quarter. They lead 35-16, 46 and a half seconds to go here in this third quarter. Shotgun, low snap, picked up. And the pass thrown to Andrew Wilson-Lamp, a little bubble screen, and he is stood up at the 20-yard line by Watkins and knocked down there. It's a fine tackle by Watkins. It'll be second down and 10. may have. Massillon doesn't have to run a play here before the start of the fourth quarter. And don't necessarily look like they're in any hurry to do so here as we're down to 12 seconds to go here. And yeah, the Tigers are going to go ahead and let the clock wind down here into the fourth quarter. And they'll be looking at a second and 10 from the 20 when we resume action on the other side of the field. More scores from Tyler Carey. How about this? Mayfield came into tonight undefeated in Division II Region 5, having a great season. They are tied with Riverside at 14 apiece, headed to overtime. Dave Boers and his Beavers came to play tonight. I mean, we saw that game last year. That's a good, you know, it's not a rivalry in the sense, you know, Mayfield isn't necessarily very close to Painesville, but because of the conference and everything, it's been a hard-nosed competitive battle the last couple years, and it certainly was last year in some bad elements. This year is just absolutely a shocking game. I would not have expected Mayfield to have struggled tonight like they have against Riverside, but it's going to overtime. And keep in mind, Mayfield's got to play Kenston 2 weeks from tonight in the regular season finale. So, I mean, long way to go in this one. By the by, here's a stat for you. No penalties on either team accepted in the third quarter, apparently. Yeah, still 7 for 98 for Massillon, 8 for 50 for Barberton. No accepted penalties. I use that term, accepted penalties. There were some hankies on the field. But much cleaner, certainly, than what we had seen in the first half. So, Terrence Keyes Jr. now 25 carries, 158 yards, and 4 touchdowns, averaging 6 yards per tote tonight. Longwell, 7 of 12 passing, 122 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 pick. Haywood, 9 of 11, 165 yards, 1 touchdown, and now 2 picks after the interception a few moments ago. Second and 10, Longwell looks, throws, pass caught at the 20-yard line. It is Beasley, goes to the 25, and like that Ballard, I should say, and he goes out of bounds at the 20, I think I spot him at about the 29-yard line, about a yard short of the first down. And it'll be third and 1. Jaden Ballard gets 9 yards on that play. And for Ballard, that will be his 5th catch of the game. 5 catches for 89 yards and a touchdown. Got a late fullback checking in here for the Tigers. Now they're ready to go. 3rd and 1 for Massillon at their own 29. Out of the pistol, they'll go to Keyes, and he'll have the first down to the 35. And Terrence will move it forward to the 37-yard line, maybe the 38. And a first down pickup for the senior running back. They have gone to him early, and they have gone to him often tonight. You know, 25, it's his 26th carry. He may have 35 carries by the time we're done tonight. First and 10. Here's carry number 27, and it's a big hole to the 45-50. Keys to the 40. He's to the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Massillon Tigers. 5th touchdown of the game for Terrence Keyes Jr. That one from 62 yards out. That puts him well over 200 yards for the football game. Well, it's you know, they always use the boxing analogy, jab, 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 and knockout. But that's kind of what you felt like there with Terrence Keyes Jr. Just continued to just kind of hammer away and hammer away at the middle of that Barberton defense. And finally, he found a huge crack of daylight, and with his speed, uncatchable. Extra point for Bauer is up, and it is good. Massillon leading now 42-16. 21 unanswered points for the Tigers. And doing so after, really since the 2:02 mark before halftime. Really since then, it's been all Tigers. But say what, you know, depending on how, forget how this game ends up score-wise. For the first time, maybe this entire season, Massillon's been tested tonight. And they did a good job responding to the adversity. And really played very, very well since halftime. More finals. Perry over Lakeside tonight, 51-20. Akron East over Ellett, 47-0. Kent Roosevelt held off Revere. That's a big win for the Rough Riders, 21-20. Hoban now, after it was 14-6 at halftime, Hoban now leading Padua 44-6 in the fourth quarter. Something similar to what we're seeing here in this one. Wadsworth over North Royalton is more scores in a second. This is going to be a squib kick that will go all the way into the end zone for a touchback. I say a squib, which is kind of a knuckleball down the middle of the field. Wadsworth over North Royalton, 52-33 in the fourth quarter. Brecksville leading Nordonia, 46-30, fourth quarter. Brecksville Bees might make the playoffs this year. They're having a renaissance-type year. You know, all the great years they had under Jason Black with Tom Tupa Sr. as his offensive coordinator and the Tupa Sons running that offense when the when they were in the Southwest Conference. And Coach Black stepped down a couple of years ago, and I still keep track of him. Really one of the great guys in high school football, anywhere you want to meet. But had a bad couple of years, but really have turned things around nicely this year and having a terrific season. Magics will take over at the 20, first and 10, as it'll be Vega getting the handoff. He'll throw, pass caught Johnstone at the 30, first down, and then he is pushed back and wrestled back down at about the 29. They'll give him forward progress to the 31-yard line, 11 painful yards, and a first down for Joe Johnstone and the Magics. And again, we've called his number a lot tonight, Robbie Page, leading the charge on that hit. Page and Murphy, I can't imagine you're going to find two better safeties in all of high school football in Ohio, certainly not in Northeast Ohio that I've seen, than Page and Murphy. They really are terrific. 11 minutes to go in the ball game. Shotgun for Haywood. First and 10 at the 31. Fake handoff. Fakes the bubble screen. Rolls. Looks. Now he's in big trouble. Down he goes. Back inside the 25. C.J. Harris led the charge, and we've got flags everywhere. And Ethan Tobin came in to help finish it off. And also in there, I think John Kuth was also in there for the Tigers, and we'll check on the flag here. Personal foul. Somebody for Barberton, I think, didn't appreciate the hit on the quarterback, and it's going to be personal foul against the Magics all the way back to the 11-yard line. So you got the sack, and then you got the 15 yards to boot. And it is going to be second down and Norton from where we're at here. Second and about 30. I drove by Norton on the way here. That's about what it is. Haywood will move his running back McKinney over to his left. Second and 30 for the Magics. And now Massillon's just going to pin their ears back and come in. Haywood pumping once, now throwing it. Double coverage, looking, and the pass is intercepted. Intercepted at the 45-yard line. T.J. Williams gets the interception for the Tigers. They'll mark it at the 44. Looking for McKinney, who was kind of trying to run a wheel route. We've got another flag down in the backfield. I would imagine probably either unsportsmanlike conduct or a personal foul. We've had that in bunches here tonight. But third interception by the Tigers defense tonight. One by Woolard, one by Page, and one by Williams. Let's see what the verdict is. Dead ball, personal foul, Barberton Magics. Any more? Nope. Okay. So from the 44... this would move it up to the 29-yard line, and Massillon will start there with 10:20 to go in the football game. And this is now going to make things even more chippy here as Massillon, after getting everything that they can handle from Barberton for the first 2.5 quarters of this football game, now starting to pull away. And, you know, imagine the trash talking is starting, and we've seen now back-to-back personal foul penalties against Barberton. And first down and 10, Longwell looks to throw, will loft one left side. Pass is almost intercepted. Went through the fingers of Jerron Hodges. And on the far side, I believe that was Charles Hornacek, who nearly had another pick six. Yeah, if that ball is just a little bit more up in the air, Hornacek might have been able to go to the distance the other way with it. It'll be second and 10. And, you know, Massillon trying to put an exclamation point on this baby. After having not played Barberton in 24 years, trying to exit here with a big win. Second down. Here comes Keys, who already has five touchdowns tonight. Here he goes again at the 25. Oh, and he's brought down by Watkins inside the 25, down to about the 22. But we got another flag down. This one, I think, is going to be a holding against Massillon. So wipe out that gain. And a sarcastic cheer by the Barberton faithful, many of whom are still sticking around, although some have already headed towards the exits. 42-16. Massillon leading Barberton. And again, it was 21-16 Massillon after the pick six by Hornacek with about 2 minutes to go in the first half. 21 unanswered since that point by the Tigers. As Longwell looks to throw, fires one deep down the field left side. It's up for grabs, and it's incomplete. Was looking over for Ballard and Spragling. Spragling had good coverage, knocked it away, and then knocked Ballard down. I think the Massillon crowd on the far side was looking for a penalty, and they're not going to get it. I think everybody's looking for a penalty at this point. It'll be third and 10. Actually, it's longer than that, isn't it? They're going to spot this at the 39-yard line. They need to get to the 19, so it's third and 20. It says third and 10 on the scoreboard. But after the holding penalty, it's third and 20 for the Tigers. Two receivers each side. Out of the pistol. Low snap. Longwell's got it. Some pressure. Now he's in trouble. Down he goes as Turner and Brunty will bring him down back at about the 47-yard line, the two defensive ends for the Barberton Magics. Also, Nick Plasinski helping out on the sack as well, and Massillon will punt as Magnus Haynes will kick it away. So after the interception and the penalty, Massillon started inside the Barberton 30, but that holding penalty and the sack stymie the drive, and it'll be Ryan Watkins in single safety at his own 10-yard line with 8:45 to go here in the fourth quarter. Good snap for Haynes, and he gets the kick away. High kick, but short, and it'll bounce inside the 30 and be out of bounds near the 25-yard line of the Barberton Magics with 8:33 to go here in the fourth quarter. What else do we got here from a man, Tyler Carey? Let's see. It is a final. Mayfield beat Riverside 20-17. Billy Guzzo with the game-winning touchdown catch in overtime after Riverside got a field goal to start OT. Mayfield gets the touchdown. They stay unbeaten. They are now 8-0. Big, big win for the Wildcats tonight. Ohio State leading Northwestern 14-3. That's in the second quarter. Hoban is now a final, 44-6 over Padua on that Perry game. By the way, I said Lakeside. I'm sorry, Perry over Lake, 51-20. My apologies. All right, so first and 10 now at the 25-yard line for the Barberton Magics, trailing 42-16. And before they can run a play here, we've got a stoppage. Timeout, Tigers. Two more remaining for them. Yeah, if you join late, don't let the fact that it's 42-16 make you think that this was a blowout game, which I think a lot of people coming into this game tonight expected that it would be the 7-0 Tigers, the defending runners-up in Division II in the state championship game, losers to only Hoban last year. Everybody thought that, it's going to be Massillon, they're going to win, and they're going to win in a walk-away. Barberton, in every facet tonight, I think I said earlier, they did not want to go without a fight. And they played hard tonight. They played inspired football on homecoming. And, by the way, Caleb Vega, who we've called his name a couple of times tonight, he was named before the game as the homecoming king here at Barberton. So it will be small consolation immediately after the game, certainly. But congratulations to Caleb Vega being named the homecoming king for Barberton here tonight. And the crowd tonight brought it. This was a great atmosphere for tonight's game. And, of course, whenever you involve Massillon, you're going to have that as Haywood looks to throw. Fires one deep left side. He's got a man open. Incomplete looking for Vega. Vega had a step on his man, Preston Hodges, just a little overthrown by Chase Haywood, and not by much. Otherwise, that's a 75-yard touchdown. Nice job by Vega splitting the zone there and nearly busted a touchdown. It'll be second down and 10 with 8:28 to go here in the fourth quarter. But I think Nate Moore will, and it'll be interesting to talk to him after the game. I think he got what he needed to see tonight from his Tigers, that, you know, they're going to have to play McKinley in 2 weeks from tomorrow and at Tom Benson Hall of Fame Stadium as Haywood will throw on second and 10. Stops. Now he's under pressure. Down he goes, back to the 15. He tried to flip it, but I think they're going to say he was down, and I think that's the right call. Down at the 15-yard line. And it looked like Woolard was one of the two Massillon Tigers. Actually, no, make that Noah Richards. He was the first to get there. And then also in there was Dylan Gerritsen for the Tigers. So that will be a loss of about 10. And a third down. And 20. I'm going to have to reset the play clock here before we start here on third down and 20. Yeah, I mean, it will look like it came easy tonight to the Tigers, but it did not. But having said that, you know, Massillon was able to compose themselves after that pick six and play some very good football. As on third and 20, they'll go ahead and run the football. Here comes McKinney. And he'll take it across the 20 out of bounds at the 21-yard line. Gets six, but he needed 20, and it sets up a fourth and long. And we'll see how it all shapes out here. As you know, Tyler gave some of those other scores we had earlier in Division 2 in Regions 5 and 6. But we'll see how it all shapes out here. I felt coming in looking at Barberton, a loss tonight wouldn't necessarily knock them out of the playoff picture because of some of the other teams that were in and around them. So we'll wait and see. Joe Itell, I'm sure we'll already have a projection by the time we get home tonight from these games or whatever. But as Barberton will look to punt, Vega will punt it away. And Eric Thurman in single safety at his own 48. As they have given Jaden Ballard, before we can actually run a play here, there's a flag down where Thurman is. And a penalty against Barberton. So move it back 5 yards to the 16-yard line, and Vega will have to step back earlier. Vega had a 44-yard punt, his first one, and then his second punt of the game was for minus one. So we'll see how this one goes. Good snap, and gets the kick away. This one is considerably better. It will go at the 42, but again, takes a roll inside. And it's at the 42, I should say, of Barberton. And as Vega goes to punt the football, he was jawing with one of the Tigers. I think Kalen Woolard. They were jawing at each other, and we got more flags, of course. A lot of emotions in this one. And at some points, it's gone a little bit out of control. And the officials at times have had issues keeping control of this football game as well. So they'll figure out where to spot this one. Another final in. Brecksville, the aforementioned Bees, beat Nordonia tonight 53-30. It's a nice win for the Brecksville Broadview Heights Bees. Well, let's see. Look, I think it was offsetting, by the way. Well, let's see. I think it was. I looked down at Tyler's score there. That's ball to 41. Are we going to keep it there? I think we are. All right, so offsetting on sportsmanlike conducts. Fantastic. Okay. 7:18 to go in the fourth quarter. 42-16 Massillon. And they've still got most of their ones in there, up 26 here at this point. Here's Keys. And he'll run left side. He'll get inside the 40 and take it down to the 38. About a gain of three, second down and seven. And I don't mean to make it sound like, you know, Nate Moore's trying to run anything up, but it's just at this point, you know, under 7 minutes to go, Keys well over 200 yards rushing, and he's got five of Massillon's six touchdowns in this football game. Pistol look here, and I would imagine we're going to see a steady diet of Keys for most of the rest of this one. Back to Terrence on second down. He's to the 35-30. He's to the 25. Steps inside the 20. And Keys will be brought down at the 16-yard line. 23 more for Terrence Keys. He might be approaching 300 yards the way we're going here. Ball down at the 15-yard line. It'll be first and 10 there. Five touchdowns. And they may give him four carries here from the 15 to try to get a half dozen here. Let's see here. I'll more scores here. We'll have in a second. Try to unravel some of the computer points here if we can. Inspector Carey helping me out there. They'll go to Pfeiffer, not Keys, and Zion Pfeiffer will get a couple down to about the 13-yard line. Gets about two. It'll be second down and eight. Oh, come on, Coach. You can't take Keys out now.
It's going to be a three-hour game.
You may have heard my man Sam Borquin over to my right saying it might be we're approaching a 3 hour game tonight here. We are. This will be, I think, long well to throw, looks it over the middle. It goes in and out and back in the hands of Jaden Ballard, and he scores a touchdown. Oh, he had it, he lost it, he got it back, and Ballard with that 6'2" frame dove into the end zone for the touchdown. His second touchdown catch of the game, his 12th of the season for Aiden Longwell, his 18th touchdown pass. And a wild game like that deserves a wild-looking touchdown by Jaden Ballard. Unbelievable. It was like a volleyball there. Here's the extra point. It's up and good by Alex Bauer, who's gotten quite a workout tonight, 7-for-7 in the extra points. But, yeah, this one, the longest game we had this year by far was Medina and Euclid. That one was about 3.5 hours. This one will approach 3 hours, though, by the time we're done. Wadsworth, a final tonight. They beat North Royalton 66-40. And Worcester beat Mansfield 18-17. So, looking at Region 6 for Barberton, of the five teams directly behind Barberton in Region 6, Worcester was the only team to win tonight. Mansfield was unbeaten, so they could jump the Magics for that ninth spot. So, or no, I see what Tyler's saying. He could jump the Generals for that ninth spot. So, yeah, but we'll see. We'll see. This, again, I don't think this loss necessarily means Barberton is out of the playoff picture. There's still two more weeks to go. 49-16. 28 unanswered points by the Tigers after the pick six by Hornacek right before halftime, as Johnstone will get it at the 5-yard line on the kickoff, makes a couple nice moves to the 20, and it'll be put down at about the 21-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 for the Magics with 5:19 to go in this football game. Oh, I didn't even think about that. Yeah, 49-16 for the first time in a couple weeks. We're going to have a running clock here with 5:19 to go, as the deficit is now at 33 points. Again, next week, we'll be week number 9 in high school football. Log on to WKYC.com, our 3 News app, Facebook, and YouTube on Monday around noon, and we will announce our 3 nominees. You have until Wednesday at 3 o'clock to cast your vote. And then at 5 o'clock, Tyler Carey and I will announce where we'll be headed for week number 9. One of the nominees, Revere at Aurora. I didn't see what the Green Men did tonight to this point, but I I don't think they were playing a team that it was expected to hang with them, so I would imagine Aurora is going to be 8-0 heading into that matchup next week. Haywood on first down will set up a screen at the 20 to the 25, 30-yard line. That's Cameron Macon. This is his first catch of the season, I think, and Macon will get a first down to the 31-yard line. I take that back. He's going to be a little bit short of the first down, I think, from where they're marking it. Got about 9 on that play. It'll be second down there, and again, the clock will move from here on in. Take that back. I didn't see the flag. I didn't see a flag down, but I guess there was a flag against Barberton. I mean, the number of hankies that have been flying tonight is just unbelievable. And it was of the large variety, that penalty, because it's going all the way back inside the 15, inside the 14, so yeah, probably another personal foul penalty. Now it's going to be first in a bunch here for the Magics. As Haywood looks to throw, steps up, looks left for Watkins, got some separation, makes the catch at the 45-40. He's to the 35-30, Watkins to the 20-15, and he'll finally be tackled inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line by T.J. Williams. But a great effort by Ryan Watkins as he was able to get a little separation and keep his footing when it looked like he was going to be brought down right at the 50-yard line. Somehow just kept his feet going and took it inside the 10 to about the 7-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Magics there. And Ryan Watkins, in what's going to be a losing effort, has played a superb football game tonight, especially on the offensive side here for Barberton. Power eye, first time we've seen that tonight. Macon gets the carry, runs left side inside the 5, and he'll get pushed out of bounds at about the 2. As Anthony Pedro will push him out of bounds there. Second down and goal.
He's just a sophomore. He's going to have a lot of good football
here. As we go under now, 2 minutes and 30 seconds to play here in this fourth quarter. Massillon leading 49-16. No quitting Barberton. Haywood's going to keep it, and he'll take it in for the touchdown. Chase Haywood gets his first rushing touchdown of the year, and for those Barberton faithful who have stuck around here as it's getting a little chilly outside, they get rewarded with a touchdown. Takes us off of the running clock. It's now 49-22. So Chase Haywood has a touchdown pass tonight and now a touchdown run. And he'll stay in there with the offense for a 2-point conversion attempt. Man, Barberton, they can clean up their penalties. They'll be a tough out these next 2 weeks. They really will be. I like the way they played tonight. On the 2-point conversion pitch out, here comes Macon, runs left, and he'll get in with a 2-point conversion. Nicely done by the Magics, as Cameron Macon will get the conversion to make it 49-24. With 2:23 to play here in the football game. Barberton will drop to 5-3 as a result of tonight. And by the way, checking in on Aurora, they played Highland tonight and they beat the Hornets 31-7. So the Greenmen are now 8-0. So Revere's got some talent, and Revere dropped to 4-4 as a result of the loss tonight. But that's still gonna be one of our big games because Aurora is locked in with a lot of other teams in Division 3 Region 9. You know, you've got Chardon there. You've got a really terrific story this year that we've been wanting to tell. We haven't had a chance to see Streetsboro yet, but they're in that region. New Philadelphia, Steubenville, Kenston, all in that region. I mean, whoever comes out of Region 9 is gonna and gets to the semis is going to earn it this year, because that's as good as we've seen it anywhere. But Aurora has an opportunity, certainly they control their own destiny for the playoffs, as here comes an onsides here by the Magics. And again, just like it was to start this second half, more flags down, by the way, Austin Brawley recovers the onside kick. And we got one, two more flags coming down. I think Eston Brown, the kicker, somebody Brown is shaken up. We have Robbie Page, who is the free safety. He was saying something to the official and was upset and now off the field. Now, all five officials are going to sort this out. You've got an injured Barberton Magic player. And I'm pretty sure, again, it's the kicker, Eston Brown. So the prime concern right now is Brown. And then the officials have to figure out what the penalty is. Because, again, I mean, there are four different flags on this field. Unbelievable. And conversely, the penalties are something Massillon's going to have to clean up because... You know, you can win like this against Barberton or whatever, but you've got to play Hoban, or if you've got to play Avon, or if you've got to play Benedictine, who we just saw last week. You can't be making mistakes like this, and let alone against McKinley 2 weeks from tomorrow. As the hankies will be picked up, let's see what do we got here after the onside kick. Personal foul. Barberton. And ball. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Massillon. Anything else? Well, I know this. Tony Gatto is 10 yards on the field and irate right now. Frankly, I don't know if Nate Moore is all that happy either. As they're trying to get both coaching staffs, but I'm right obviously in front of the Barberton staff, just trying to get the players to move away here so they can tend to Eston Brown and figure out what they need to do for him and make sure the chippiness stays on the bench. This has been another reason why we've had a number of these types of multi-flag sequences that take 5 minutes to sort out. And then unfortunately you add the injury aspect to it and you have another stoppage in play here as they're tending here with 2:22 to play in the fourth quarter. But just imagine as they get Brown on his feet and I'm not sure Eston knows right now what area code he's in here. I think he took a big shot. And they're going to help him over to the bench here area here and tend to him. And so he'll take a seat. And frankly, the best thing that could happen right now is Massillon just to run it a couple times here and let's get out of here before this thing gets any uglier than it has been. In terms of the penalties in this football game, they're going to mark it at the 25-yard line. So Massillon ended up getting a 25-yard ride back after that sequence. Although it looked like they had Barberton on both penalties, but apparently that wasn't the case. As we said, the best thing that could happen right now is take a couple of runs here and let's get out of here. And as a matter of fact, Zach Catrone is your new quarterback. He's a 5'11", 200-pound junior. And I would imagine we've got a new running back in there as well here. As Tigers just going to run it here to the left and they'll go out near the 30-yard line and then push back. And again, takes, you got eight guys in the scrum and it takes three whistle blows to get everybody to stop and get back to where they were. Second down, we're under 2 minutes now to play in this football game. Raquan Venson is your new running back. Venson's had a pretty good year running the football. 306 yards, averaging 7 yards a carry. He's been the guy a lot of times in these situations when Maslin's been up by big numbers. He's gotten quite a few carries. And they'll fake to Venson. Quick bubble screen out to the right. Pass caught by Brawley. And he'll run out of bounds near the 39-yard line. And that'll be enough for a Tiger first down with a minute 34 to play. We'll head on the field after this and try to get a quick comment or two from Massillon players and coaches, and then head to week number 9. As they'll go to Vincent again, and he'll take it out to the 40-yard line. Raekwon Vinson. As we go to a minute 25 and counting. How about, tell you what, one more run to Vinson, and let's go to a knee and get out of here. 49-24, Massillon. As this game approaches the three-hour mark. We started a little bit late, but a lot of that had to do with television as Vinson gets it again. Our friends at Spectrum are here. To the 41-yard line goes Vinson. We are under a minute to go here in Barberton. As the Tigers will go to 8-0. Magics will drop to 5-3. I think Massillon's got to run one more play here. It'll be third down and 8 coming up here. But one more should do it, and then... For the first time in 24 years, Massillon and Barberton will have finished a battle here. All right, third and 8 from the pistol. Vinson again gets the handoff to the 41, and he'll get pushed back, and that should do it. Yeah, they will play to the last whistle, but... this one is going to be over. Your final here at Rudy Sharkey Stadium. The Massillon Tigers, 49. The Barberton Magics, 24. Massillon, 8-0. Barberton, 5-3. Massillon, with their playoff hopes under their own control and playing like a team that wants to get right back to the state championship game, and this time... try to get the victory all the way. Barberton, their hopes for the postseason not yet dashed here. We'll see how things go over the next couple days and certainly over the next couple weeks. But this was a lot of fun tonight. Being here in a great stadium in Barberton and watching the Tigers and watching the Magics go after each other. Sometimes was a little bit chippy and with the flags a little bit ugly, but fun, inspired football. And in a great atmosphere and great crowds. And wouldn't expect any less from Massillon or Barberton. And we certainly got in for a treat tonight. And it was a certainly enjoyable one for that. Okay, that'll do it for us up here in the booth. We will, have some on-field interviews. We'll put on Twitter and we'll have it at WKYC.com. And we'll look forward to seeing everybody next week. You get to vote where we'll be. We'll either be in Aurora or someplace else. We'll let you know our nominees Monday at noon. At WKYC.com, on our app, Facebook, and on Twitter. Again, your final from Barberton here on a terrific October night for football. The Massillon Tigers, 49, and the Barberton Magics, 24. I'm Dave DeNatale. Thanks so much for listening, everyone, and have a great day.